Whoa, it's dark over there.
Oh, no. Yeah, it's, the roll 20 tool doesn't like to...
It's spreading.
No! Run, Volette, run!
I can see so well.
Run away, it's coming.
You shouldn't have taken the rancor.
Last we left off, you guys had started at the end of the Glassworks encounter. You opened up a few doors in that basement area, finding a very unhappy Emiko, an unconscious adventurer, as well as a mimic. But you were able to, you had Pseudo tied up, looted the place, looted Pseudo. Found a good bit of information on him in the papers, the journal. Made your way back up topside, and Miko went back to the tavern safely, and you guys were ready to plan your next move. You explored the caves a little bit, knowing there's a branching tunnel that needs exploring. Not entirely sure what's down there, but considering all that's going on, it can't be good. It was getting fairly late when you discovered it, and you guys had already been through a fight. So you rested for the evening, relaxed. You also had a game of 50 questions.
Oh, yes.
Just questions, I think.
And then later on went to bed, ready to tackle the tunnel the next day. Theodahad is already way ahead of the curve on that.
Mm-hmm. So for that, before I go to sleep, which I will be sleeping without my armor because I am not fucking with the sleeping in medium armor penalties.
Yeah.
I told you earlier this week that I had a brain blast about my shadow weapon abilities. Yeah. I realized going through that nowhere in there does the rules prevent me from creating oversized weapons that I am no longer capable of wielding. So specifically, I will be blocking off, the edge of the tunnel going to the cave, but not the, just past the Y, section, mm-hmm. cause I'm going to be sleeping right in front of the Y, but I'm going to be creating my charging shield from my shadow weapons list that I sent you, but I'm going to create it for a large creature. So it blocks the entire tunnel.
Okay. Yeah, you got it covered. And you don't get harassed in the middle of the night.
Ooh, interesting.
What a relief.
Are we planning on doing our cave adventure like first thing in the morning?
Makes sense, unless there's the stuff you guys want to do to like prepare or something.
I need to go buy some stuff, and if we had more time at the end of the previous evening, I'm okay with going to like purchase some stuff. I just can't find Adobe Acrobat's having a meltdown. How much is a common healing, like a standard like cure light wounds potion?
That would
I believe you. It's either 25 or 50 gold. I can't remember off the top of my head.
Ouch. Okay. Mama want a bad beast of healing potion.
Fifty gold.
50. I got all that money just to lose all that money. I'm thinking of that vine of the little girl throwing the doll.
I just spent 10 gold pieces on salt.
Salt.
Is there a work board, a job board in this town?
There is a job board. It is located. That's not the map.
It's okay. I was just wondering if there was. That's all. I was just wondering
there
if there
is.
Was. If we do ever need to buy or make more money, we could always do that. But we've got some pretty more important things to do, I think, right now.
It is over by the garrison.
Did we include the 10 platinum in the money that got divided?
I don't think so.
Yeah, because there was also...
We
there
did.
Was, okay.
Yeah.
Just make...
We added 100 on. That's how we got up to 700 something. 600 something.
Okay.
Make
sure. Yep. No, I did that math.
Cool. Thank you. I'm going to bite the bullet. Screw it. I'm going to do it. Is it cool if I make a couple of purchases?
Yes. What are you going to get?
I'm getting four things. One, I'd like to buy a waste pouch.
Okay.
Carry stuff. I'd like to buy a healing kit, leeches, and a cure light wounds potion.
Nice.
Okay.
That's why I was asking if I could feed ticks to leeches.
Oh, that was that hilarious joke or question. Yes. Which would win?
Okay, so healing kit and that stuff you'll be able to find in town fairly easy. The leeches...
I was going to check Hannah's.
Hannah's? Let me see. Okay, Hannah's has leeches.
Yay, leeches! Hey. Yay, Jordan!
Sorry about that.
Leeches for Jordan. Perfect timing!
Just, wonderful!
I've always wanted leeches.
I've always been a fan of lamprey, like teeth.
Think of like.
I just need to put my humors in balance.
Lampreys are such like an eldritch kind of like. This seems like Cthulhu could have made it.
Oh yeah,
especially the mouths.
Yeah, their mouths.
Sorry about that. I'm ready to go. Whenever you guys are.
Cool.
I'm just buying.
Okay, we've started doing.
We've
shopping.
Started, but it's the very beginning of the day, so.
Okay.
I'm literally here for like 40 minutes, and then I'm on the next flight. I'm in San Diego right now, so.
Woo. Gotcha.
Hey Jake, can I make a general intelligence check to see if I either heard or saw whether or not there's a temple in town?
That would be knowledge local.
Do not have a single knowledge skill.
All right. Okay, yeah. Then yeah, go ahead.
Okay. 9.
Okay. It's a DC of 5, because the temple is the biggest, most prominent building in the entire town.
Okay. So
you
if
really
people
can't
don't
miss
come
it
down...
unless you're blind.
Like immediately, because I feel like I probably didn't sleep amazing in the cave overnight, speaking of which, I'm assuming we get the hit points we get back from sleeping.
Yes.
Killer. Extra 2 whole hit points.
What are you up to?
I'm 17 out of 26 now.
Wow, 26.
Like the rest of us.
It's that 20 of constitution. It really is.
Yeah. 17 on its own is already higher than some party members, max.
I'm not super worried about it. I am going to slowly make my, if nobody comes down like early into the morning, I'm gonna put my armor on and then slowly make my way, just dismiss my, actually no, I'll keep the shield where it is for now. But I'm just going to make my way to the temple, and I want to see if they have a priest.
Okay.
Oh my gosh. Flashbacks, breaker of chains.
Yeah, so you make your way to the temple. It's... Yeah, at this time, the temple is open. Like I said, you cannot miss it. It's the biggest... Very beautifully made and definitely still a little under construction. The temple you easily find. And going inside, You see it's set up to a few... It's a temple to multiple different gods.
Yeah.
Is
it well lit?
Yes, it is well lit.
Shit.
The window, the large stained glass windows let in a good amount of morning light.
Awesome.
Oh, I thought you were asking if it was like, it's lit in here.
Oh, it's fun. We have a good time here at the temple.
It didn't even occur to me about the sun. Oh my god. Yeah, this
Father Xanax knows how to party.
Cheers to that.
Is that oatmeal stout I saw in that glass, Jordan?
No, it was not.
Oh, okay.
It's just a Guinness. It's
gotcha.
Very, very basic stuff.
That's what I forgot. I was wondering about...
All right, so you know the five gods here include Abadar, Gosre, Saranray, Shaylin, and Aristil.
Cool, cool. I've heard those names.
And you do see a priest wandering around making sure everything is going well for the day.
I'm going to walk, like, beeline to him, mostly so he stays within my 60 feet of dark vision. and I'm just going, excuse me, I don't know your name.
Oh, Father Xantus, and you are?
Theodahad. I'm going to ask you a very pointed, potentially insensitive question that is deeply rooted in your faith and your relationship to whatever god you serve. And I apologize if it is rude. Do you by chance have the capacity to channel divine energy as like a ability to do like a widespread heal?
Yes, that is possible.
Excellent. Excellent. I've recently temporarily joined a small group of adventurers who are investigating goblins. From what I understood, from what they found when researching stuff in the glassworks, I get the feeling that I'm going to need to be able to effectively combat against demons. I was wondering if I could request a use of your channel energy, your divine energy, to help with that.
Of course. Are you running around with that? Oh, really? There's only one creep in town I think you'd be running with.
The one with all of the weird eyes.
Yes, that one.
Hey, wait a minute.
The weird. I had a suspicion.
Over here, like, what?
Group name, the weird eye, or the crazy eyes.
Crazy eyes, crazy. I like it. Crazy Bronson. Eyes, Bronson's, Bronson's. Yeah.
Right. You saw where I was going.
Heal you.
All right, someone's going to have to get turned into a
no,
duck.
I don't need you to heal me. Specifically, actually, do you have a room that you don't mind coming into? Because what we're going to do is going to require a very temporary amount of time where the room is plunged into magical darkness. It is significantly less sinister than it sounds, I really promise you. I can explain the entire process before we even begin. So I have the capacity to use shadow magic, specifically... two things that are I'm doing. So the first one is I can make weapons out of shadows. I have a specific weapon that I designed but modeled after a weapon I built for one of my brothers who is a paladin. That is a warhammer whose head is a consecrated magical lantern with an ion torch in it that allows you to channel channel divine energy into it to make smites, a once a day use smite I see. I'm going to make a shadow version of that weapon to whatever god you worship with a eclipsed ion stone, so it's going to emanate magical darkness. It needs to emanate the magical darkness while you consecrate it with your channel divine energy. Then I'm just going to cover it with a burlap sack that I have on me so that I don't inconvenience other people. Is this something that you feel comfortable with doing? If not, I understand there will be no repercussions and I am just going to go back to the glassworks.
It's one of the oddest requests I've ever received, definitely.
That's kind of my deal.
But these are odd times, admittedly. So, yeah, there's a meditation room we can use.
Excellent. What god do you want the weapon designed for?
I have a particular devotion to Saren Ray, which would be a scimitar.
Scimitar? No, I don't need the favored weapon. I need the holy symbol. Is it a scimitar? I think it's an angel, right? That's just an out of character. Does he have the holy symbol on his neck?
Yes, you do see he pulls out, he does have the chain. It's an angelic ankh.
Okay. Cool. I'm going to look at it real close, and then I'm going to real quick roll a craft weapons or knowledge engineering, because those are the weapon design skills, to just modify the design in my
head. I'd say craft weapon.
19.
Okay, yeah, you can make it.
Cool. I'm going to, out of its burlap sack, pull out the eclipsed iron stone so that pulls the room into darkness, and then form the celestial great hammer around it. I'm going to hand it into him and have him bless it. Then I'm going to take this call.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll be right back.
Yep.
Okay, gotcha.
Hello, my love.
Hello. I'm going to take this call. So what else do people need to do for the morning?
Ooh, I have something, if I can interject.
Yoga. Yeah.
So a repeat of your...
Okay, so, pretty simple. With my new money, I would like to buy... Here's the problem, I'm not proficient with a lot of things.
That's good.
I believe... I don't know if I have enough money for this, that might be the other problem.
Were you able to get in?
This is gonna be really silly because, in all practical terms, what I'm about to do is probably way harder. But because I'm not proficient with a bow, I don't think. Let me double check here. Yeah, I am not proficient with bows. So... No, okay, yeah, that's what I'll do. I'm gonna go on the hunt for a light crossbow.
Okay. Light crossbow's easy to find.
Sweet. Yeah, I'm just going to buy a crossbow and, 20 arrows or bolts.
Yep, you can do that easy. Market price.
Yeah, you got it.
All right. And yeah, as you guys all go about your mornings, eventually you will coalesce together. Probably at the Rusty Dragon, as that's usually where you meet.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Morning.
Hello, everybody.
You will notice that Squeak is not wearing her poncho. For the first time. She comes downstairs. She has like a sleeveless gi with a purple sash wrapped around the waist that comes up and over her shoulder. She kind of comes on over, sits down with everyone.
I like your outfit, Squeak.
Thank you. I felt like he was constantly getting in the way. Oh, I don't know. But did he not spend the night here?
I don't know. I didn't stay the night here. I stayed at
Amico? Is Amico walking around?
Yeah, she's currently kind of almost back to normal, doing her usual duties, cooking, tending the bar. Yes. Can I help you?
Did that other gentleman at the glassworks, did he spend the night here?
No, he didn't come here for a room.
Oh no. What if he couldn't find his
way? Where he ended up.
He's lost and gone
for I'm sure he'll be fine.
We'll never see him again. I'm kidding.
No. Oh dear.
He literally wandered out of town.
Eaten by demons.
I hope he's not trying to take on all the goblins by himself.
Oh, no fool would do that.
You'd say that.
Don't no tempt fool. Fate. Okay, no, take that back. Don't tempt Justin.
That's right.
The only reason that's not happening is because Jacob is actively the DM. And he can't do it himself.
That's true.
You're okay. Fair.
I would like to just recall back to a previous Jacob campaign where Justin and I single-handedly subverted the entire boss fight.
Yep.
I was playing
the entire last session of the game.
Yep.
That was amazing. On the moon,
it was
right?
Like was three nat 20s and a natural 100 in a row.
That's insane.
The stars aligned.
Not only did you roll to skip the encounter, you managed to survive skipping the encounter.
Teleported off the moon before, it's fine.
Where should we go? What should we do?
I mean, I was under the impression that we were going back down into the tunnels.
Same. Right, the new...
Oh, what if Theo went down the new branch all by himself?
He wouldn't do that.
Nobody would do that.
After I go to the temple, I'll probably go back to the bar.
Okay.
Yay.
So yeah, you'll make it there probably the last of everybody since you had some business to take care of first.
We leave 5 minutes before he gets there.
Jacob, I do need to know what his channel energy damage is.
It is...
Like the number healing. Of dice.
Yes, let me pull that up.
You mean healing, right?
No.
Nope, okay, I screwed that up. It's not Saren Ray, we don't have to re-roll anything. It's Desna.
Okay.
But it's the image of the butterfly instead of an angel.
I'll kill her.
Alright, so that is going to be...
I want someone to walk past the meditation room and just look in and just see a woman going like this on her phone, like, interesting prayer.
2d6.
Oh, they can't see you.
2d6?
Yes.
That would be awesome, though.
Okay.
Interesting prayer. Yeah, maybe I can... I can scare them away if someone comes in through that door.
Excuse me, I'm in the middle of a deep trance. Oh, sorry.
Do you jellyfish too? Do you believe in the butterfly goddess?
The shadow hammer. And then I'm also going to use one of my... vials of holy water to fill the head of the hammer to increase the safety C.
Okay. Save DC is going to be... save DC base is 15.
Okay, so it's now 16.
Hey, guys are all packed, ready for whatever is down that tunnel.
Certainly.
Nyrelion actually has his backpack with him.
I'm also going to actually go to my... cart. I just thought about this and actually get a weapon that isn't a shadow weapon. I'm also gonna grab my cold iron morning star.
Ooh, okay. I see one with that adventurer's kit.
Hell yeah.
I'm going
That's one
to,
of my favorites to get.
Bring my short bow with me. Since I don't know how far this is gonna go.
Mm-hmm.
I gave Trent the healing potion, correct?
Yes, because you said he was the most responsible.
Which I do it under raising protest, too.
We took that personally.
Well, I bought another one. And I'll just put it out on.
Oh, I'll take that one, too.
No.
You should keep it.
I'm just saying I have it, but I don't really know how this is going to go down. So I just want to say overall, Trent, I'm just going to follow you like a shadow.
Fair enough. Although, there's not really any shadows under... Well, I guess there's still shadows underground.
I was going to follow you, like a shadow.
Oh, I see what you're saying. Okay. I'm tracking now.
I don't know.
I mean, we took care of that pig pretty well, so we make a good team.
We do, yes.
Oh, yeah, you guys do.
I was thinking then, if I'm following you and I have a potion, maybe we should give that one... to someone else, or I can give one off. Here's the thing, if anything were to happen, I can't do what Edan can do. I can stabilize you, but I can't pick you back up.
You could just shove the potion down the throat of whoever goes down.
Yes, I could do that, but apart from that, any other thing I really can't do.
But she'd probably be better off fighting in a bad circumstance. Edan, are you kind of like, do you want to just be our healer? Are you interested in helping us that way, or what would you prefer? Because maybe one person could be the runner to get potions.
I mean, unless we can use knowledge of the gods to take out our enemies, I think I'm best served healing.
I haven't seen knowledge kill many goblins, but there's a first for everything.
I mean, they're not particularly bright.
I suppose lack of knowledge usually is what kills them. I mean... If we want to kind of spread resources around, I could give this spare one to Nyrelion because he seems to get hit the most.
Yeah, that works.
That does seem to be a recurring pattern.
I'll dig around in my couch and just toss you a potion. Just totally just like, here you go. Not careful at all.
So guys, I'm going to move to my gate because they do want me to
responsible
be on time.
Exactly.
I'm going on mute.
Exactly my point.
All right, well...
Right. Where have you walked in yet?
have I walked in?
Yes, you've entered by now.
Cool. I'm walking in.
Hello.
I have. Hello. Actually, Squeak, you're. I have something for you. I got to thinking last night before I went to sleep. I actually have, and I hand you a wrapped, like, oilskin pouch. I actually have one of my brother's surgeon's tools. So I feel like you might get more use out of that than I will.
Oh, I can hold on to it.
So if you want to use that, fair game. I mean, my brother doesn't know I have it, so.
Oh, no. What
Which brother?
Do?
Nikon.
What do surgeons do?
That clears things up.
They up the healer's kit bonus from a +2 to a +3.
I was just trying to be polite.
Thank you. Wonderful. All right. I feel more prepared. Huzzah.
Nobody left the tunnel last night.
No, nobody came out of the tunnel.
No, I'm saying that. Way, yeah.
Hold on.
How are you?
Yeah, I slept down there.
You did what?
Oh my god.
Yeah, in front of the Y section, so to make sure nobody came out.
Oh, dude, we left a 9-year-old in the tunnel alone.
That feels...
Okay.
He's fine.
This might be a low moment for us.
Not one of my finer moments. Oh no. Well, I'm glad you're all right.
I mean, I feel like I would have been fine.
Okay.
Feeling and doing can be two different things.
And yet, despite the odds, I'm still alive. Everything's
despite
looking
the
up.
Odds.
Which means I hope
they
don't
recognize
the
odds.
In the cave. Oh boy. All right.
Either
well,
way.
Yes.
All's well that ends well, right? To an extent.
Everyone, make sure you eat a good breakfast.
Oh, I already have.
I know you've had three.
I got some more funnel cakes on the way here.
All right, well, shall we head out before anything has a chance to enter or leave that tunnel?
Yeah.
Probably wise.
Let's go. Are we going to go back through the glassworks, or are we just going to go back up the cave?
Probably the glassworks. I think it's the more direct route, right?
Fair.
I think it's probably closer.
Yes.
All right. Onward ho.
You guys continue on back towards the glassworks. Nothing's changed from the previous day. Guards are still there when you head on down, they're outside the tunnel still.
Morning,
Chad. If we don't come back in like a couple of hours,
send some help.
We'll notify the mayor.
That would be great.
No, but see if Shalelu's around. Maybe send her in after us. She seems capable.
We'll let them know. And so you guys head on down into the tunnel.
Secret tunnel.
Understand point. Secret tunnel.
To the goblin.
And die.
Solid.
So you guys, going down towards the Y intersection, make your way towards that cave. Map will begin bottom left corner. Go ahead and drag your tokens in for marching order.
I would like to say that I will be hanging out with Edan.
That's probably a good idea.
Yeah, you're going to have to drag her token on. Because I can't access it.
Okay.
Yeah.
And if you can give me control of it so I can move it.
Yeah.
Yes.
You guys can skip me in combat, because that'll just make sense, because there's no reason to have someone be two people, I guess, Zach, unless you, Jake, want that, then Zach has me. But otherwise, you can just be like, oh, Volette just, like, freezes in battle or something. Or gets knocked out immediately. And then it's like, alright.
Then you just drop down in like the Skyrim idle animation, right? You just kind of run around and then you're like,
hey, you're finally awake. You were trying to cross the border, right?
Yep.
Right.
It's perfect.
Volette blacks out, wakes up on a wagon.
Hey, you.
What happened?
Why are we not dragging today?
Whatever you want to do, Jake, in this circumstance, because I will be. Out.
Oh, I'm leading the way. All right.
I'm trying to get my token in front of you guys. It's not dragging.
I can lead the way. I've got no problem with that.
Here, let's see.
There we go. Thank you.
Ooh, that makes Theodahad a wide boy on that map.
Oh, yeah. It does not. Actually, you know, that's a good point.
Get that portrait in there.
Yeah, let's just use the portrait that Noah spent probably too much time on after I answered his questions.
Make sure you have your raccoon in there too, if Rags is coming with us.
He's just going to be in my cloak.
not a battle raccoon.
No, despite the fact that he does have 13 hit points, he is not...
A raccoon have more hit points than me.
It's a sturdy raccoon.
I mean, he has half the...
This is depressing.
He has half my hit points, and I have a lot of hit points.
There's no shame in not standing up to Justin's power gaming.
Yeah, no.
I mean, I'm kind of happy. Like... I think it's an achievement that I have more hit points than is familiar at this point. I'm like, hey.
Let's roll the image quietly.
Glad you're in the front.
It's a question. I think, Justin, you can correct me, but I'm pretty sure we put the two dumbest people in the front of the group.
I'm not dumb. I just don't have a modifier.
So I'm dumber. You're dumb and I'm dumber.
Do you have good perception?
Hey, my perception's good now. Good.
I got a plus 3 to it.
I'll cast light if you want it on a coin, Trent, and you can put it in your pocket if you don't want it.
What?
Seriously, why does he not want to drag shit tonight?
What'd you say?
Light. Oh. You're being given light.
I'll just have it on my sword so it looks really dramatic.
Well, it can be on your sword or it can be on a coin if you wanted to put it in your pocket, if you wanted to sneak up at all at any point.
Well, I just sheath my sword.
Or that.
The lights will go out if you stab anybody.
Symbolic. I've plunged them into the darkness of death. No, coin is probably smart. That way I could throw it at somebody. I was like, aha, surprise.
Take our light source.
Wait a minute. Grot, is that you?
I was going to say, it can't blind anybody, but it could make one of our party members blind. So yep. maybe not.
Here, I also did this really quickly. I'm just imagining this is Zach's or Justin's raccoon.
Nice.
Okay.
Disturbing.
He does have an 8 strength.
Swole
which
raccoon.
Is pretty good for a raccoon.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Most halflings. Just saying.
Alright, are we moving or no?
Let's do it.
Let's go.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so you guys head on down.
This dark tunnel?
Not with the light spell.
Nope, I am.
Hey,
so...
my coin isn't working.
All right, just backing up a little bit.
Like traditional flame, so that you can actually see.
Just moving tokens back one step, because you guys do come across as you round the first corner. You get to see into this room. Let me reveal the area.
I also realized that Gloomblade totally could be used as an excellent way to emulate Tears of the Kingdom's weapon fusing mechanics.
So yes, as you guys head on down the tunnel and come across this first corner, you guys, coming around the corner, see these things.
Oh, crap.
Right.
These
Real
things,
quick.
What a way thought, to start.
Wait,
the...
I thought we were all
piles
saying
and piles
yes,
of garbanzo beans.
Quietly. We said
yeah,
quietly.
We did say we were going to stealth.
Okay, I missed that. Go ahead and roll stealth.
Don't worry,
guys. Hey,
guys.
I can't move you guys farther back on the map, but we can say story-wise, you're
Oh my god, Fantadon.
Oh, sweet, nat one.
Yeah, can we just say
that's no. a total of zero, baby?
Yeah.
Natural 20.
I got 4.
It might be better if I don't try to stealth.
17.
What's the worst that can happen? We've already got a 0 and a nat 1.
Oh, 17.
Well, might be a nat 1 with a minus 1.
Nice. Okay, 2 nat 1s.
A minus 1.
And we're the first to go in the group.
What did you have?
Minus 2.
I got a 14.
The two that have the worst.
I got a 14.
Would you get the worst modifiers? Got really
this this dice has rolled officially in California. So, yes, I am. Woo.
Hey, California. Yes.
My one roll. I knew that I needed this dice.
I think you mean Cali.
Sorry.
Don't even get me started. Don't even. I hate that.
Triggered.
That or when people say you're from Frisco.
Oh, yeah.
Fuck off.
Has anybody ever asked you?
Diego, how's that?
God.
I haven't heard Frisco, but I have heard San Fran.
Some people call it Frisco. I hate Frisco.
That's like
San Fran,
old-timey thing, isn't it?
Yeah, it's old.
Isn't Frisco like a 1830s thing?
That's Crisco.
No, that's still around.
I use it for pies. I rolled an actual 20-23.
Okay.
I was about to say, I'm pretty sure Frisco is an actual town, but it's in
Texas. What did you get?
Oh, Zach, will you add myself to 14? And just type it in the chat for people.
And Noah, what did you get?
17.
Oh my. You rolled a what, Jess?
I rolled a 19.
No, what'd you roll, Jess?
I rolled a 14, so add the mod.
Do we not have anybody with ranks in stealth?
23. Oh, no.
I do.
Well, that's good.
Apparently somebody does.
Well, that's good. She's got a plus 9.
Oh.
Nice.
Okay.
Sneaky bard.
Okay. Nice, that's...
You would think someone with as high a dex skill as I have would be better.
It's the armor thing.
Perception?
Me?
Stealth.
I'm wearing light.
Oh, you're wearing light?
Yeah.
I'm wearing medium.
Armor is for smart people.
Armor's for non-mugs.
Okay.
you're just too wise.
My flight's boarding, guys. So see you. Love you.
Have a safe flight.
Hope you guys have fun. And
bye.
Yeah, it's like a 3-hour flight. I'll text you, but I'm pretty sure it lands around 11. So you can leave at like 10:30 or whatever, and just leave it running.
All right. Make sure
the computer doesn't go to sleep. So set the settings to different.
I will talk to you guys.
Don't open the emergency door.
Okay.
I heard about that.
Oh yeah. Okay, so you guys going carefully and quietly. All of you also roll me perception.
Guys, I'm okay at this one.
17.
24.
There it is. 16.
13.
Jake, I do have a question about the nature of this cave.
Okay.
Oh, actually, 12.
Does this look like it was made by people or animals? Like, does it look like it was dug or hollowed or scraped or, like, paved? Like, are there, brick walls in here?
Support beams?
No. This part of the cave is natural cave work.
Hmm. Like, lava tunnels?
Kind of.
It's just all...
It's definitely not man-made, is what it is.
It's giant mole people. I've seen this episode.
But you guys,
Alaskan
as you get...
Alaskan bullworm.
Alaskan bullworm. Maybe someone shattered that.
We need to take Sandpoint and push,
push
it
somewhere else.
All right, so you guys, as you come up closer to the corner, about 15 feet away, you hear almost kind of like this rasping sound and just this deep, heavy breathing.
Love it.
Avoid it?
It'll be better to leave it behind us.
Yeah.
Be on guard, I guess.
So as you guys come up closer towards this side entrance, you guys see this. Oh, nope, I need to actually put in your journals.
Jake, we need to set up a time for I can run you through the dynamic lighting.
Oh, yes. Yes.
Oh, no. I don't like those things' names.
All right.
Okay. All right.
You come around the corner and see these two things also coming up out of this side cave towards you guys. Go ahead and roll initiative.
It's clobbering time.
Please change the music.
Something really creepy.
Yep.
Oh, jeez.
Sunshine, lollipops, and do do do.
Did it not go through?
Nice. Oh, I don't think it did.
Oh, it did.
Oh, yeah.
It didn't add me to the initiative tracker, but I got a 20.
Nice.
Well done. Well done.
Guys.
Oh, I got a nat 20.
Hey.
I wish we could set up like a thing, like someone rolls a 20 and, you know, foghorns go off and...
Confetti, and you get a piece of candy.
Confetti, yeah, there you go.
Kind of like the it's the birthday party from Halo.
Yeah, oh, yeah. A grunt birthday party.
You can throw it in the soundboard. We could have a natural 20 sound and a natural.
Oh, we should.
Oh, that's good. That's good.
I'm gonna. Ooh, these things did not roll too well.
There we go. What's this sound?
I decay my BFF gel.
All right.
Oh my goodness.
Yes, I forgot you put that on there.
I decay my BFF gel.
That's what we hear as we're coming up the hallway.
I guess I can roll.
That's the sin.
I can roll for Volette.
TFN.
As well. If you want me to, Jake.
At this point, we'll just say Volette's here, but I'm not going to throw her in initiative.
Oh, but she could use days.
Should I maybe step in front of her? Just for the purposes of...
Well,
you
if
know,
you wanted to put her in the initiative, she got an 18.
We'll use her turn to stare at the wall.
She casts days at the wall. She casts days on herself.
That's what we did to Noah.
Yes.
We did that to Noah during a game we were playing. It was a big fight. We didn't have his character sheet. We're like, he will spend his turn admiring this lovely piece of stalagmite coming out of the side of his wall.
Yep.
What did you roll for? Oh, Tuff, you got 20.
Yes. It made it in roll 20. It just didn't make it onto the turn order. I think I didn't have my doodad selected.
Yes, Ethan.
That is my name. I'll roll.
It fucking counts.
All right. Brent, you are first.
Ethan.
All of a sudden, I turn into like a 7-year-old who's mad about not getting to go to Disneyland this weekend.
All right. Well, I'm gonna do what I do best, kind of. One, two, I'll make room for others, actually. One, two. Don't leave me hanging, guys.
Oh, boy.
Okay.
Given flanking.
Wait, so you're moving...
Leroy
Jenkins.
I
guess that provokes
that
an attack.
That would be... Yes.
You know what? I'm going to stay there. Yep.
I made myself a name tag.
All right, I'm going to attack.
Yes.
I will attack blue. Now the question is, do I trust roll 20's dice or do I just roll my own?
I'd say give it a shot. If it disappoints, then you know.
Don't do it. It's a trap. It's a trap.
Oh, it's a trap. 10.
It's a trap.
10 is not.
Oh, it would have been an 18. It would have been a crit.
Never trust the roll 20 dice.
All right.
So unfortunately, you miss, as this thing is. These things are fairly agile. It easily ducks out of the way. Just its mouth hanging open and just slobber kind of. Almost kind of getting spit all over the place as it moves.
Oh, you're like too ugly to hit with my sword.
Belong in a museum of ugly.
Right, it's Aang.
It belongs in a museum.
So Edan is going to
Ethan.
Yeah, excuse me, Ethan. His twin brother is going to step up here. And I guess I'm gonna load my fancy new hand crossbow. I'm gonna forego the shield for now.
Okay. And loading it
is a move action, so.
Yeah.
Can I just do it as my standard? Is that cool? I think that's
yep.
Kosher.
Did you move? Yeah, you can do that.
I moved. I didn't see you move.
He was in the back.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
With that, Theodahad.
All right, I'm going to take my great hammer that I've had in my hands this whole time. I'm going to do my swift action for a object interaction to rip the burlap sack off of my hammer, which then means that I radiate. I lower the light level by one in a 20-foot radius around me, and then it becomes dim light in a 40-foot radius around me. I'm going to take a 5-foot step up forward with the hammer and going to swing with all of my might and not accidentally exit out of my character sheet. does a 22 hit?
22 will hit.
Okay.
That'd be really frustrating.
So I'm going. I'm going to do 9 points of bludgeoning damage. And then 2 points of positive energy damage. Unless they make a DC 16 will save. Otherwise, they take 1 point of positive energy damage. Unless they are not evil.
Oh, God, no. Evil. No, these are evil.
Cool. And they are damaged by positive energy as, like, a fiend or a...
No. Watching it, it feels about what you'd expect.
Cool. Then I completely. Like more vulnerable?
No, it's not more or less vulnerable. It's cool. About average, about what you'd expect.
Well, then I waste my once a day half damage channel smite on the swing.
Oh no!
Oof.
Whatever. It was a gamble, and then I'm gonna take. My move action to change my weapon to a laser torch so that I am not impeding the vision of anybody around me.
Okay.
And that is my turn.
That. Nyrelion.
Okay. First off, looking at these things, do these things look undead?
Go ahead and roll knowledge.
Arcana?
If you're going specifically for undead, yes, Arcana.
Okay. 26.
26, okay. With that, they're definitely not... They're not undead, definitely.
Okay.
They're... looking at them and judging by their appearance and how they interact, you did see one get hit with just this kind of flash of darkness. Mm-hmm. Did nothing extra to it, as far as you could tell. And with a 26, you think these things are aberrations of some kind.
Okay.
Shit. I was betting on demon.
It's a good bet, given the...
Honestly, given the information. Yeah.
I can't get into melee range without eating an attack of opportunity, can I?
Nope.
Yeah.
In you can bull rush one of them. That would still provoke an attack of opportunity, though.
Yeah. In that case, I'm going to move to here just so I can see a bit better. I am going to place my hand on the hilt of my sword, and then with my other hand, I'm going to pull out a small lump of butter from a pouch on my belt and cast grease.
Oh, God.
Ooh, okay.
Such a good spell.
Butter time.
Is that why Nancy was carrying around that weird pat of butter in her inventory the whole time? She was just waiting to cast grease on somebody?
Those weird times all around. I'd believe it.
Johnny Rutter.
All right, and where are you casting grease?
I believe it's a 10-foot square, so I'm going to cast it. Here, I'll draw it out. I'll draw it out. There.
Okay. So these things need to make reflex saves.
Yep.
DC 27.
DC... Because I forgot to buy a thing I meant to buy. It'll be DC 14.
Right. Here, I'll use the roll 20 thing. See if that works for me.
But it likes the DM.
Does nope. Work for you.
Yep.
Okay, hit a mixed bag. So green one fails and it falls prone on the ground.
Awesome. Perfect.
Blue slips a little bit, but keeps its feet and remains steady.
And yeah, that is my turn.
Right. And with that... Weak.
Does prone give... It gives a minus two an attack, correct?
Correct.
Minus four. Attack.
Minus four.
No, it gives a minus if it's affecting you.
I can only do... I can't do anything unless I get into a space with someone. I'm literally useless, so...
It'll have a minus four against attacking you.
I'll eat the attack of opportunity. I'm going to try and get in here.
All right. I will try and see if this thing can. Attack of opportunity from where it is.
Minus
with a minus four, 16.
17!
Oh.
So this thing lunges out, tries to bite your leg as you run by, but it's way too slow. Still slipping in the green.
Oh my gosh.
Excuse me, bite?
Bite?
No, sorry, not bite, claw.
Okay. I was going to say, because if that thing can bite, I was going to be a whole lot more worried.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to skirt around the corner. I'm going to say, I told you, like a shadow. And I'm going to take my action to try to an aid.
Okay.
Oh yeah, that beats it. So you get a plus three to your next attack. Actually, which would you... Shield or hit?
Well, there's only two of them, so let's hit.
Plus three to attack. That's my turn.
And probably that... should have picked shield. Oh well.
Fuck.
We're about to find out.
I just realized, oh wait, they're both going next.
Yep.
All right. And they get their full attack.
Ding dong on the floor.
Green's not going to try and get up. You see these things as soon as you guys begin getting in combat with it. It's almost kind of a bloodlust. They see you. They get incredibly agitated, hostile, and it's almost a fervor of trying to kill you.
It's not a great sign.
So Green is going to, on the ground, try to bite, or two claws first. Two claws at Theodahad. What's your AC?
My AC is 18.
Yep, so the two claws, first one swings, misses, second one catches your leg, but it doesn't get through your armor. Turning around, going to try and bite Trent. That also misses.
Are there penalties for being prone for melee attacks?
Minus four.
Got it.
Minus
four. Okay.
You get a plus four attacking a prone creature with melee, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, yeah. I just couldn't remember what it was for the attack prone creature being the attacker.
Yeah. Blue is going to attack of two claws at Trent and one bite at Squeak. And what is Trent's AC with the plus three?
No, I didn't have the plus three.
I gave it to you.
Just
attack.
17.
Oh, okay. 17. Well, it rolled horribly, so no.
Huzzah!
And then going to bite at Squeak. No, I'm not using that die anymore.
No, I keep using it.
No, I think it's... You're rolling all the bad numbers out. I'm sure it's only a matter of time before it rolls well.
Did it miss?
Yeah. You know how dice work.
It missed.
Right?
It crit failed.
Yay!
It did not roll... It rolled highest is a 16. The next highest number was an 11 in all those rolls.
It chipped a tooth on a stalagmite. Oh, that's it. Combat's over. Good session, everybody. Jake has left the building.
Sweet, we won.
Yay!
You know, I haven't used my Eldritch Horror dice in a long time, so I'm going to use those.
Nice. I just sent you a question, by the way, Jake.
Okay, let me see.
Believe it or not, Noah, I can answer that question. Those aren't Gary Busey. Sorry.
Oh my god.
So with that, after missing horribly both them, Trent, it is your turn.
All right. Swing at the blue one, using my dice this time, not... Boosh. 26 to hit.
26 will hit.
Sadly, not a critical, but almost. Almost.
17?
It was a 16.
You crit on a 17?
No, I crit on an 18.
Okay.
But soon. Ish. Soon. But soon being like level 9, I think.
Soon.
I can dream.
Way far off in the future, but soon.
The distant soon.
The distant soon. Oh, minimum.
That's going
damage.
In band name.
5 damage.
5 damage, okay.
Take a quick step if you can.
Oh, yeah, good idea. Boop.
Yep.
So 5 steps don't.
5 steps don't provoke. But you can only move 5 feet.
Gotcha. Okay.
Yeah. It's super useful, especially for casters.
Very helpful for tactical movement. All right, that's my turn.
All right. Ethan,
Ethan.
Ethan.
I'm gonna
start calling you Ethan.
Oh no.
I know it's gonna happen.
All right, so I'm gonna step up right here. So here's the question, Jake. Yes. Do I still take the -4 for this thing being in melee if the melee is happening, like, not directly in front of me? Yeah.
Yes.
I just kind of look down at the crossbow, and I look at this thing. How hurt does it look?
Green or blue?
Blue.
Blue took a sword hit. Not terribly bad. But it definitely has been hurt.
And I just kind of...
Alright.
Don't shoot me.
There's a 4-point range for that.
Well, I didn't shoot you.
Oh no.
I rolled a 1.
Oh no.
Yeah, that doesn't shoot anybody.
Oh.
So you fire off this crossbow and it goes, hits the far wall, peens off to the right, peens off to the left. Ricochets a good bit, almost hitting a few people, until it just shoots to the back of the room and clatters to the ground.
Well, hey, that might have been a waste of money.
Edan might want to practice with that a little bit more.
Sorry.
Also, thanks for the help, Squeak.
Problem.
You make a good shadow.
Thank you.
Hey, Dad.
Alright, I'm going to continue to hit the green one with my laser torch.
Okay. You get a +4 to hit.
Dirty 20. And... that is also against his touch AC. Just
that will definitely hit.
Okay. And then he's going to take 7 points of fire damage, and then so Nyrelion can theoretically come and join us. I'm going to take a 5-foot step to here.
Okay, so 7 points of fire. And as you hit this thing with fire damage in a grease area of effect...
Oh shit, fuck.
Yeah.
The entire area erupts into flames.
Oh, God.
Well, I can't see shit, so, blinded.
Oh, God.
These things get...
Just everyone for just...
All right.
Wait, don't you have dark vision?
Oh, that's true. It is not
not magical light.
Right. It's not magical light. Cool, 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 cool.
All right. So with a ear-shattering, high-pitched scream, the green one erupts into flames and then dies.
Oh, that's a lot of noise.
The blue one also erupting into flame. Gets burnt, but the oil burns away, and it's still standing, but very badly burned. Grease effect is gone.
Good luck selecting that box.
I got it. Oh,
there it is.
Hey, look at that.
One of my biggest gripes about Roll 20 is so hard to select anything that you draw on the map.
I mean, if you just select one part of it, it'll select the whole thing.
A box, and I eliminated half of a party. I deleted everyone off. After everyone had all their roles set, everyone's things just...
So, like small things, it's not too bad, but if you do anything like a larger area of effect for like a fireball or something...
Oh, yeah.
Nope.
Mm-hmm. You get everything on top of it.
Which, you'd think that should be a tool that they have of like a cone and... radius, you know, they should have tools to show that, but
yeah.
Is there something you can pay for that'll give you that?
Not that I know of.
I mean, I have a paid account, but I don't have a better
Fantasy Grounds.
I haven't
Fantasy Grounds.
Mm-hmm. Honestly, for $5 a month, like roll 20 is worth it.
Yeah.
For the stuff you get.
Yep.
That okay, roll 20 it's can worth use it. My audio interface, but Discord can't is ridiculous. Just saying.
Oh, yeah. And the fact that you get unlimited storage space is probably the biggest thing.
Yep.
Ooh, that's nice.
I could that not, nice. Like, I found that near the end of our campaign, we did, like, go off of it just to, you know, like, oh, we don't really need this. And I was like, oh, wait, I can't upload anything because the storage is, like, 500% full.
Yeah.
Never mind.
Nyrelion, it is your turn.
All right. So, yeah, you can draw a weapon as part of a move action, right?
Yeah, it's part of moving. Yeah,
plus one BAB, yep.
So yeah, as I move, I'm going to draw my sword. And then it's no longer burning there, right?
No, the flames, it's kind of like a flash fire.
Yeah, okay. So then I'm going to step over Green's body into this corner here.
And
cut down at blue.
Okay.
How injured did Blue look?
Blue is fairly injured.
Okay.
Yeah, maybe a good whack or two would kill it.
I'll use a power attack.
No, okay. You gotta let Squeak use the people's elbow.
The people's elbow. That's going in band names.
That's a crit.
Oh, no. Nope. You're not getting the chance. No.
So this will be
just for fun. Natural 20.
Okay, this thing was very dead.
This die. I love it.
24 damage.
Nice. How much? Kill it.
24 points of damage.
Jesus.
All right, I'm starting the dead leaderboard. This thing is at negative 15.
Oh, yes.
Very nice.
Oh my gosh, looking back into it, the last post, Alvern is an honorable mention.
Yep.
That fire elemental.
Oh my gosh, that fire elemental.
Rest in peace. Got shredded by a hallway of plants. Oh man. So it begins.
And with that, you guys are out of initiative.
Anyone ever seen anything like this before? Doesn't really seem all that natural, if you ask me.
It's definitely an aberration.
Something about the face.
Jake, would a religion check give me any help on this?
Go ahead and try.
That's exactly what I was trying to channel there.
As a total of 12.
You have no idea what this thing could possibly be. You just know it's horrifying to look at, and as soon as it saw you and started trying to kill you, it kind of just flew into a rage.
Ooh, unrelated question. Can I peek down this hallway and make sure nobody's coming at us? I have 60 feet of dark vision.
60 feet, okay. I'll give you...
I think that's 60 feet, right? That's a... How many Aasimar?
That's generally the stock standard, yeah.
Yeah. Just, you know, making sure nothing's trying to eat us.
Mm-hmm. So you see there's another fork in the tunnel there. And 60 feet... Okay. You see, way at the edge of your vision. Oh no, that's the hide areas. The tunnel does continue down and branches off to the right again.
Okay.
Well, time to split the party.
If I
three more. Volette, come back here, the, right, the rest of us will go this way.
You know what? With Jess's luck, she'd be the only one to survive.
Yeah,
she would walk out of there and be like, "Well, I didn't see anything."
Unguarded treasure room.
Just like this, yeah. Distant screams in the background. I hope they're doing okay.
I really love all these tiaras.
All right.
Well, Jake, since I can see perfectly fine in darkness, what, out to an infinite range, can I see anything when I finally go back into spot for being first? Or does it curve further too
than
soon?
That, because it does curve to the left.
Curves again? Okay.
I'll ask.
There's nothing
it.
Else in this cave, correct?
But I don't think it's going to amount to much.
No, so this cave... Yeah, so this is kind of just a big, or not very big, but definitely like just a side area. There's nothing in here. It's pretty much completely empty. Still, again, all natural stonework.
Is there anything worthwhile on their bodies?
Oh, the loincloths are probably worth a few coppers.
I gotta ask.
Absolutely not.
Yep.
Is there a taxidermist in town?
I think there is.
Surprisingly, yes.
I think we looked one up.
I'm just saying, a stuffed head probably would sell for decently well.
I don't know that it would.
I mean, as a Halloween prop, yeah.
A little too much. She tried to stuff.
I'm pretty sure that guy at the feathered serpent would buy something like this. Seems like right up his alley.
Remind me never to get on the feathered serpent then.
Oh no, it's a fantastic place.
It's a wonderful place.
Especially if you want rings.
Really expensive rings. Or a masterwork flute. That's newly stocked.
Oh, that's nice. That was that where the flute found its temporary home.
Tis indeed.
Got it.
Temporary home for the next 20 years. Like most of the other stuff in that shop.
You know, one of these things might look quite fetching with a flute in its mouth.
Looking down at these things, one of them like still smoldering and the other one like fucking cut in half.
Mouth parts, yeah. Like all open and
displayed and gross.
I don't think that fetching was the word that you were looking for there, Ethan. Eden, yeah. Sorry. No, Aiden. I'm sorry.
It's Ethan.
Ethan.
Get it right.
You gotta get it wrong the right way.
Right.
Right. Well, adventure continues, but I say we need to keep on our toes. More than likely, there's more stuff down here.
Are we continuing to stealth, or did we assume this battle basically fucked us on stealth?
It's probably fucked us on stealth.
Yeah. Unless it's much farther away, those things
the screeching,
pretty loudly
aberration.
When they were burning.
There's no chance.
Oh, that. Those were the alarms. That was a functional, like, organic tripwire right there.
And nobody's hurt, right?
I don't
no?
believe anyone got hit.
Well, they are.
It's close.
Well, yes.
Yes.
I, funnily enough, I forgot to lead them into the everybody.
So quick guess. Question.
Back to marching order.
Mm-hmm.
These things, so, like, I figured out they were aberrations. They're vaguely humanoid. Do they look like they might have once been humanoids? Or do they look like completely off the base?
Roll me a heal check for that, for anatomy.
Okay. This is not going to be good. Two.
Solid.
I mean, they bleed, so maybe.
Monsters have blood. People have blood. They could have been people.
Oh,
and just
God,
like numbers and like a montage of like connecting the dots.
Does that look like Amico to you? Oh no.
Alright, so continuing down. Eventually you guys come across this first tunnel that you can really see.
I mean, I'm kind of thinking we go right, try to explore this tunnel system as much as possible.
Stick to Trent.
Okay.
That's why I left a spot there.
Oh, for a second, I thought you were saying you wanted to stick to me too. I'm like, everyone just wants to follow me around.
Groupies.
We'll get a little rope, and you guys can hold on to it.
No, I want to be like, I'm going to just cast light like for like half a second all the time. Just pretend like I'm taking pictures of you.
Dude.
Trent, where are you going today? Have you been anything interesting lately? Sorry.
Looking down this tunnel, you see it does turn into a more man-made room. The room is, instead of a natural cavern, it's a square room. The floor goes to tile. And it's covered in just debris.
Well, that might be good to check out.
I mean, that seems far more interesting than that tunnel.
Yeah. My vote's for that way.
That works for me.
Very well. You're in front.
Charge. We had the same plan.
So yes, you see before you is a very, very old wooden door. The wood's partially rotted away at this point, but still standing and technically functional.
Does it look like a push or a pull?
Roll me perception.
Can you see the hinges?
9.
We left okay, it's a push.
It's a push. Everybody ready?
I'll move in a little more so more people can fill into the room.
We're going through a door.
Thumbs up for me, then.
I'm gonna push it open, hoping it is not locked.
You push it open and it just swings open easily.
Without a noise? Interesting.
And it leads, it's a little bit of a creak, but it's not horribly loud.
Oh, that's a narrow hallway. Burning whatever that was to death.
Yeah, it leads into a just a similar, same architecture and everything. Just a tiled floor hallway that curves to the left.
What's the composition of the debris in the room we're standing in?
Go ahead and roll perception.
Nat 20.
Actually, ooh. Nice. I was going to say I'm going to help, but you don't need it.
Nat 20 for a total of 20.
All right. So looking at through the debris, it's definitely a lot of old pottery.
Mm-hmm.
A long time ago, definitely held food stores.
Okay.
At this point, they've crumbled away to dust. It's old.
Mm-hmm. What do you...
Seems to have been some sort of cellar space.
I've got a sneaking suspicion that this hallway might link up with something like down that other branch. It branched to the right, too. I'm wondering if it meets up over there. And this is a really narrow hallway for all of us to squeeze through.
Well, you suggest we...
Like a kill box, almost.
Well, I'm thinking if there's another little cavern with some, you know, whatever those things were, might be best to not be bottlenecked. That's what I'm thinking.
I'm done. I'm fine to head that way.
I feel like that's smart. Do you mind if I go down the hallway and confirm?
Feel
just
free.
Just right here.
Yeah, should I?
Nah, just wait for me. He'll be fine.
Okay.
So yeah, looking down this hallway, you see it. Well, with your infinite vision, see it leads down to a few different areas. First, immediately is a turn to your right. Past that, it continues down. You see it branches off to the left and right, also into a bigger chamber that you can't see from where you are. And at the end of that chamber hallway continuing is another door.
Staying where I am, not moving, do I hear anything?
Roll me perception.
dirty 20.
No, you don't hear anything from where you are.
Cool. Then I am going to walk back this way. So it looks like the tunnel that branches off ahead connects up to this corridor. The corridor does not widen out, but it looks like there is three exits down that corridor. Two rooms, one with a smaller door about the same width as this corridor. A room that's got, looks like it's an open entrance that's about twice as wide as this corridor. And then at the far end, going up, down, parallel with the tunnel we just left, there's another wooden door.
All right. Well, I guess three of us can go the other way.
Are we sure that's a wise idea?
No.
It's it wouldn't do well for us to all get stuck in a fucking narrow hallway and not be able to do anything.
That's the
just
thing.
Get whittled
like if we
down
get,
one by one.
If we get into a fight with anything in a narrow hallway like that, it's just going to be 1v1. We don't get to take advantage of numbers.
That's true. As long as we try to stick together as much as possible.
It sounds like it connects fairly close.
Yeah, we'll just meet up where it connects and go from
okay.
there.
Good enough.
All right, well, I'll go up the natural cave side.
All right.
And
I think it's Squeak you're going with,
Trent.
Means I should probably go with whoever's
going. Well, I'll go with Theo. All
right, well, Volette, you want to... Volette will come with me then.
You do have...
I'll just kind of, like, hook her arm.
Followers.
I just...
just skip down.
I can't really hook because I'm much taller than her. I'll just hold her hand.
Actually, like you're leading a 5-year-old through the
dungeon. I'll take the sash she has and she'll just like take off, like unwrap a
part
of
it.
Just wrap it around her and just pull her.
She can ride on my shoulders.
Put her in a backpack.
And the Bjorn.
Perfect. Perfect.
Like a baby papoose.
Oh my gosh, guys. Idea for a small size or smaller caster just
oh
worn as a backpack on one of the fighters.
Genius. I played a caster that was in a wheelchair and got pushed around by his familiar. That was a good time.
That was a good character.
That was a wild character.
All right, so go ahead and put your characters where you're entering from.
I'm right, or I'm either to the side of, or I'm right behind him.
Okay.
I can put Bill there.
Blink.
I mean, we're just gonna
move
up here. If
anyone comes up behind her, I can help her.
Okay, so as you guys continue on, for A-team, you guys see down this hallway, it continues on for a little ways and then turns to the right.
Mm-hmm.
As you guys come up to B3, little bit of panic as you turn around the corner and see a figure there, really quickly realizing it's a statue. A red marble statue of a strikingly beautiful but at the same time monstrosity enraged human woman stands in the middle of this room. Her stony expression twisted in fury. The woman wears flowing robes, and her long hair is held back from her face by an intricate headdress of hooks and blades. In her left hand, she carries a large book, the face of which you can see is inscribed with a 7-pointed star. And her right hand holds a glittering metal and ivory ransour.
Is it like a real ransour?
You want to investigate?
Can we see it on the map?
Yeah.
Yes. Oh, and you see down to the right as it continues, there are stairs that lead down.
Can we see further up?
Yeah, what about the natural cave?
Natural cave. You see.
Ooh, come on. A wall down there somewhere.
Hey, look at that.
A square.
Okay. You do see it ends in a doorway.
We've got a door over here.
We've got the female hallways over here.
Well, which one first?
I bought yours.
I mean, flip a coin, I guess. I would say we probably shouldn't go down just yet.
So some of them
do the stairs go down or do they go up?
I think they go up, right?
Stairs go up or down?
Double checking.
I thought you said down.
Okay. I'm using a slightly different map from the book. These ones go up.
Ah. Well, I don't...
The map I have has the arrows going the other way, but... Yeah, this one... Yeah, stairs going up.
Well, I don't think we should go up just yet.
Real quick. Quickly. Does somebody want to look at this statue?
Yeah, could I ask, so since when we read the letter, like when we read Sudo's journal, and the journal mentioned Lamashtu, and I got a good knowledge check on Lamashtu, does this look like it might be Lamashtu?
Go ahead and roll knowledge religion.
Well, that's a worse roll, but I got a good roll on Lamashtu last. That was a 9.
9? It's kind of hard to tell.
Does it have a plaque definitely... that says Lamashtu? I love the idea of you just like really looking at it really hard, and I'm like, oh look, a plaque.
If you want to see if you might know who this is, go ahead and roll a history check.
Okay. Nat 20.
What does that come up to for history?
23.
Okay. You're not sure. It's definitely no ruler or person you've read about or heard about, or at least not seen a picture of. The description of her doesn't match anything you've seen or read before. And there's no placard with a name.
This begs a question. Where are we? We're not under Sandpoint anymore. So where are we that we have?
We're under Sandpoint still.
I thought we were north of the town because the other branch of the tunnel left out of the beach.
The other branch of the tunnel went north of the town.
The other one, I think, went in.
We're somewhere. The city.
We should be somewhere under the city.
Town.
Huh.
Maybe those stairs go up to the surface again.
It would make sense if it connects. There was like old pottery and like food storage stuff in that little room back there.
Where? What building would have an extensive tunnel network under it?
The temple?
Does it look like it's been used?
It could be under the temple. That is entirely possible.
I mean, I feel like if it's been in use, those things back there would have.
What are we
rolling? Yeah, well, that's what I'm trying. I have a feeling it hasn't been, but I wanted to see. 21.
21, okay. So, looking around the room and everything, a few things you notice. One, this place is definitely very, very old. Relatively clean. You're not sure about the debris out front, but this place, there's a bit of a lack of dust. You're not sure if it's because it's been cleaned or if it's just because it's in an old cave system that hasn't been touched in years. You do notice on the statue itself is, again, fairly clean. And the rancor it's definitely probably the real deal. Like, it's made of ivory, and the blade itself actually glints with metal.
Hold on.
I mean,
can I cast detect magic?
Go ahead.
I don't know. Can you?
I cast detect magic.
You do not feel any magic.
Okay. Ooh, ran sewer.
Let me see real quick. I'm trying to remember Pathfinder versus 5th edition detect magic.
60 foot cone.
And you're just from where you are, Nyrelion cone?
I moved up because I was looking at the statue. Okay. I'm gonna looking in the direction of the statue.
I'm going to go check this door down over here.
I agree. I want to check that door as well.
I'll check out this door then.
Okay.
Everyone, find the door and open it.
Can I grab this ransom?
How's
it secured?
It's not really secured. It's definitely in her hand.
Mm-hmm.
But it's not specifically attached to the statue. Go ahead and give me a strength check.
That I can do.
As that is happening, Trent.
15.
You pushing this old stone door open leads you.
It's a Tarrasque!
It's a mimic!
Lead you to what looks like the inside of a prison cell that you can see looks out this way. You can't go beyond the bars are right there, so you can't really move beyond. Meanwhile, Justin, as you open the door up here, you come into the same room. Yours is about what was the height difference? That was B6.
Oh no, guys.
Okay, you're about 10 feet up. You coming into this room, you see what looks in front of you, the same prison, a wooden platform, and opening the door, you see two more of these things.
Oh.
Okay. I was worried for a sec that, like, we had just found our way into, like, the city jail, and that might have been the cell Suda was in.
Yeah.
We're just walking. Hey, buddy, we're busting you out.
Like, he's one of these things. He turned into them.
This is a prison break. Oh, all right. Geez.
Go ahead and roll me
like, initiative. We didn't beat you up enough
Hold
last
on.
Time.
Did my 15 strength check get the ransomware out?
What did you roll?
15.
Yes, you did. It took a little bit of tugging, but you managed to get it out.
Mm-hmm.
Everything.
Yeah. I'll just, like, hook that to, like, my backpack.
Hey, we got the same initiative.
I think your deck score is higher than mine.
I think so.
Their deck score is shit.
Hey,
that
look.
Tracks.
We're good.
That
oh,
tracks.
No. Oh, no. You got a fancy new ring. Sort of
okay,
like
I mean, everyone... I guess it's becoming a thing. I think Noah, your Nyrelion is constantly the last one in the turn order.
Yeah.
Not this time.
It's a zero initiative mod.
Well, you're always at least last in the party.
Oh my gosh!
Very nice. Very nice.
What is your dex score?
Zero. The mod is zero. The score is 10.
Mod is zero. Score is 10. Okay, then green goes before you.
Oh, yep. Damn.
Yeah, saw that coming.
Still not a great score, but it's above 10.
Everyone's going to push past you. Like, come on, Nyrelion. We got things to fight.
As soon as you open this door, Justin, you see these things, and they, like the other ones, and the rest of you can hear them too, just this ear-piercing scream as they charge you.
Shit.
Cool. It is my turn, though?
Turn. Yes.
Cool. Well, shit. I'm going to do move action to change my shadow weapon. I've got something I think it'll be better. I'm going to change it to my spiked charge wall, so my two-handed spiked tower shield.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm going to brace, use my action to brace for charge and attack them.
Okay. And what does that give you?
You are now a door.
So the spike charge wall, it's a tower shield. I can only use it to attack if I brace it against a charge or I use it as part of a charge. And while I have it pressed like that, I basically I give myself full cover until I attack with it. And once one of them charges against me, I can use my reaction to make a single attack against them. And then I lose all my bonuses to AC. Also, okay. I take a fucking huge-ass hit to my attack roll because I am not proficient in shields at all.
Oh my god.
Damn, okay.
Right. Bold strategy.
But I don't have to attack, and it's just straight up, I have full cover.
That's pretty And
nice. I've blocked off the door. Which is what I'm doing. So I basically I put a two-handed tower shield in front of myself and I'm blocking the door. That is my whole turn.
Okay. Yeah, these things can't attack you. They'll come on up. They're so yeah, they can't
attack you. Did they get a turn?
Nope, sorry, never mind.
It's like, wait a minute.
Ahead of myself. Squeak, it is your turn.
No, I believe it is Trent's turn. He has a higher dex score than I do. Oh, wait. That means I rolled higher than you. No, it's dex score.
On a tie, it's dex score.
Yeah, so it's you.
Yep.
Okay.
Right now, I kind of wish it defaulted to the person who rolled higher.
One, two, three, four, five, six.
This is open, correct? Are we in a cell or like?
I don't. We can't get through it.
You, yeah, it's a prison cell, but the cell door is closed.
Gotcha.
I guess I could check if it's locked, but I'm gonna assume it's locked, and I'm gonna move over here.
You move on over, and you see, hey, Dad. Completely covering the doorway with a giant shadow shield.
Oh, well, looks like you've got it covered.
Just to hope it.
Right.
I guess I'll take... I don't know. I'll use my... I'll just move there for five with my standard action. So I'm kind of out of the way, but close. And that's my turn.
Okay. Then Squeak.
I'll check the cell door. Is it locked?
It is locked.
Cool. So that's what? 10, back to 20. What about... 10. Back. 30. You can't do anything.
You can move more. If you're not
doing anything else, you can move again, yeah.
You can okay. Standard action to move, too, okay. If you wanted to.
Well, I checked the door, so I don't know what that counts as. Like, I went to go rattle the door. So I'm assuming checking the door is an action.
That's up to Jacob.
Know.
I mean, running up and pushing on a door and then running back.
Yeah, know. I'd say just use your swift action.
Okay, then I will doink. That's all I can do.
Right. And with that, Ethan.
Ethan!
I'm pretty sure... Yeah. That's great. Ethan.
Um, really got nothing.
I can't do anything.
I'll get right here, but yeah, that door's blocked up.
Volette's gonna move right here.
Actually, you know what I will do? I'll get, like, right behind Theodahad, so that if anything bad happens...
It also happens to you?
I know, Noah.
Motions you not to. Don't move there,
all right,
please.
All right. I'll give you a chance to do whatever you're gonna do.
With that, it's a green's turn. They're going to come up. They really can't get at you. You're under total cover, and they can't get around because it's in the doorway. Nyrelion.
All right. Well, with this trusty ran sewer I just fucking picked up, I'm going to step here, because I believe ran sewers are a reach weapon. I'm going to stab past Theo here and try to hit this thing.
Mm-hmm. Four tower shields, they do only provide total cover one direction on one side of the thing, so he can't stab past me.
Okay, that was going to be the thing I look at.
I figured. I have read up on the tower shield rules.
Thank you. All right, yeah, so go ahead and roll to attack.
Okay. Is there any like a modifier to the attack with the Ransor?
It is a masterwork ran sewer, so you get +1 to attack.
Okay, cool. Fuck it, I'll power attack.
I don't think they have very good AC.
That'll be a 21 to hit.
Certainly not that good.
21 will hit.
And then does it ran sewer, if I remember right, that's 2d4?
2d4, yes.
Cool. Eight plus seven is 15. 15 points of damage.
You rolled 2 fours on the dice? Points.
I did roll 2 fours on the dice.
Max yeah, damage. You hit this thing, hear a scream in it. Kind of hard to see, but you're able, you definitely heard it badly. Mm-hmm. And with that, Blue is going to come up. Blue also can't attack.
Can they not, like, bull rush or anything?
Not from how far away they are.
Also, they can't. I have total cover. Bull rush is an attack. As total cover, I am considered, inaccessible for melee and range attacks. That doesn't have any effect against, like, spells and stuff. But I've basically constructed a wall for my use only.
Got it. Okay.
Yep.
Interesting.
And it is your turn.
Okay. I am going to not use my move or my swift action. I'll use my swift action to... I'm going to pull my left hand out from the wall. I'm going to grab my cold iron mace. I'm going to open the shield slightly. My hand is going to take its full attack action to make a single melee attack with the...
Your hand is a different creature.
Yes, it is. The whole point of having a makeshift tower shield is so I can attack and still use the fucking tower shield. I'm going to make a... single attack with the or the hand is going to make a single attack with the Morningstar. It is going to roll a natural one. So nothing's going to happen. Then I'm going to use my standard action to pull back in and set and reset the total cover.
Can we move past you or no?
Yes, you can, because it's only considered total cover for attacks coming towards me.
Okay.
And that is the only thing it's considered total cover for. So you can move through my space as you normally would.
Okay.
But we can't pass them, right? We can't move through their spaces?
You'd have to make an acrobatics check, probably, or a bull rush through them.
There's a corner.
Yeah, if you snuck out in that corner, but I don't know, can we... Yeah.
At that angle, it would still require an acrobatics, because you can't go directly through. You have to go through the doorway and around.
Is that your turn?
That is my turn. Sorry, I forgot to say that part of...
Okay, so if I were to try to take that move...
Oh, is that going to provoke attack of opportunity from blue?
That's fine. What's that ruling? What's the acrobatics check for?
Just to move through acrobatics there. Check. Move through their space and avoid the attack of opportunity.
From green. Specifically.
Blue, probably.
No, I don't care about avoiding the one from blue.
Yeah, from green.
Okay. I will attempt to do that. I'm going to be bold here. Acrobatics is gonna be a 22.
What is your speed?
30. And I was only moving 15 feet.
Okay, cool.
Is blue taking an attack of opportunity?
Blue is definitely taking an attack of opportunity.
I will opportune parry and riposte.
Okay.
Oh. Shit. Swashbuckler.
I'm pretty sure I just stopped it. I just got a 25.
Hell yeah.
Oh.
Ooh, yeah, let's see. Yeah, you definitely stopped it.
So, I know previous Swashbuckler I played, I kind of rolled it as like, if I succeeded, that roll was my attack roll. I think the rules kind of, I think they could be interpreted either way. Do you want me to make a separate attack roll or use that attack roll?
Go ahead and use that attack roll.
Okay, that's a critical.
Okay.
Not great on the roll, though, unfortunately. It's going to be 11 points of slashing and 2 points of fire. And that would be one of my panache points. Oh, but I actually immediately get it back because that's a crit.
Because of the crit.
Never mind.
Gotta love a good crit fish build.
Oh yeah. Mm-hmm. Swashbuckler is a beautiful thing.
And what did you roll for the acrobatics check?
I rolled a 23.
2?
Yeah, that'll be enough.
I'm next feat is going to be lightning reflexes, so I can do multiple of those in a round if I have to.
Mm-hmm. Nice. Sweet. So yeah, you were able to move through their square.
It's okay if you don't follow me, Squeak.
Yeah, I physically go on. So an acrobatics check to get through, does that takes half movement to get through that section of the there's no physical way I can get into this room.
Can we not go diagonally?
I think it's half movement through the enemy.
No,
square,
getting right? around this whole wall and everything's gonna take all that time. I don't have enough space. Even with half movement, I'm on top of you or I'm in its square.
Because you can't take that diagonal?
One? Because I have to take half. I have to get there in 15.
I think it's... Is it half movement the total? I think it's just half movement.
It's just half movement through that one square.
So this this would count as 30 feet right here, what I'm measuring.
To that opposite side of the floor. But I can't go through it. I can't go through its square. I have to go around it. I can cut
that's
through
what,
yours.
That's what the acrobatics... No, that's what the acrobatics check is for.
I thought the whole point was acrobatics makes you take half movement, not a half to get through that space.
So there's the acrobatics is to get through the enemy's space, but there's another way to use acrobatics to avoid attacks of opportunity, which you do have to decide to use half movement or not.
Well, my question is this move, is that disallowed?
Jake was saying that we can't make that corner. You can't cut that corner.
Okay. That's the part I missed.
Yeah. I wasn't doing acrobatics to avoid an attack of opportunity. I was doing it to move through green square. So you could, if you really wanted to, move on the other side of green.
Wait, what is... You have 30 feet of movement?
Yeah.
So that's 20 and then 30 to there, right?
Yeah, you'd be able to make that.
But that's... Okay.
Basically, think of it like this takes 15, 20, 25, 30.
Oh.
Count the enemy as difficult terrain.
Yeah, so like when you leave an enemy square, it takes 5 feet extra to leave.
Oh boy, well.
You don't have to, though.
Yes, I do.
All right.
I'm your shadow. Acrobatic. I can't leave. Wait, hold on. I thought there was no acrobatics check. Now there's an acrobatics check?
You only... Since it's required if you're moving through their square. If you're moving around their squares, like through a threatened square, that doesn't require it. But in order to make it through an enemy, you have to roll acrobatics.
13.
Unfortunately, that's not enough.
She moves. It's for the attack of opportunity.
Nope.
It was just to get through.
Oh.
If you attempt to move through an enemy space and fail the check, you lose the move action and provoke an attack. Oh no, you do.
So lose the move action. What does that mean?
Because I can't get pushed.
Yeah,
back
you stop moving essentially.
But where?
But how?
Where?
Yeah. How? Yeah.
How? That's... I'm stuck in a door.
There's nowhere
for me to go.
I mean, you'd say
hit a limit of the rule.
She would spit out to the next closest open area, right? Which would be the square that she's in right now.
That's true. She would spit out to that side.
Yeah, it's just so functionally nothing happens
except the attack of opportunity.
You get the attack of opportunity.
Well, there's only one, right?
Just the one, just from green.
What is your AC?
17.
That will hit.
Oh. First hit I've ever taken, guys. Here we go.
It had to happen at some point.
Yep. 3 damage. As this thing reaches out and slashes you with one of its claws.
Okay, this might be fine.
Well, full attack actions, though.
Yeah.
Edan, your turn.
Who's Aiden?
Aiden. Is that the name of one of these creatures?
Yes. They're all named Aiden.
If you have a ranged attack and
wait, hold on,
you can still fire through my space.
Wait, hold on. That was just my movement. Can I not do anything?
Yeah, you can. Yes, you can. You can still attack.
Okay, cool. Sorry, yes. Yeah, it's still my turn. Okay. Green hit me?
Yes.
I'm going to punch green in its face.
Hell yeah. You are flanking.
I am flanking. Okay, oh! So that gives me plus two.
Yeah. What? Guys, I could have attacked green.
I didn't take
my standard action. That was the whole point of like.
If you had attacked green and killed green, then Squeak would have been able to move through no problem.
Shit, hold on. Do we need to back up here?
Hold on.
That was my whole freaking plan.
Go ahead and roll an attack. We'll see if it hits.
Okay, I'm sorry. That was my whole plan was. Opportune parry, riposte blue, and then attack green.
I feel like it's going to be a 20.
It was not. It's a 17.
Ah, close enough.
That'll still hit.
Gosh, this d6 is not rolling well. 6 points of damage.
Okay. This thing is horrifically wounded, but still up.
Dang it. Sorry, Squeak.
Is it staggered?
No, it's okay.
It's staggered.
Almost.
Fine.
Okay, so it's on one hit point.
so it's plus two.
Yes.
For flanking?
Yes.
Yep.
21 to hit.
21 will hit.
Falcon Punch!
Max damage, 7.
Oh, nice. Ooh.
Okay, yeah, this thing's dead.
Nice.
As you quickly spring to the side, catching a claw to the back. You quickly swing around, punching this thing straight in the face and hitting it against Theoden's shield, and it collapses to the ground.
Theoden has entered the chat.
Theoden. Oh, shit. We're safe.
Death! Death!
Flurry of blows. I'm going to punch blue. I'm going to use a stunning strike.
Ooh. Okay.
Let's go. 19 to hit.
19 will hit.
It needs to make something.
A fort? Fortitude?
It needs to build a fort. It must build me an acceptable fort, and if I say
it's an attitude,
we'll live.
Yeah, that's right.
It must build a fort with attitude.
Build a fort with attitude. Yeah, 18. It'll succeed.
Fuck.
Dang.
5 points. Bludgeoning.
Alright.
I mean, I don't know how much hit points they have. That might have been enough.
I don't think blue's been hit.
I hit it with a crit.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, I did.
Is it still alive?
Math is difficult.
Math is math.
No, it is close to death, but it's not death.
Oh, man. That would have been cool. Trent and Squeak busting onto the scene just... slaughter these guys.
All right, and with that, it is Ethan's turn.
Ethan. Jordan, by the end of this, you should just cross out whatever and just add names, and you'll just have a name tag with like 50 names on it, just different variations.
And it'll end with 118.
Let's hope it doesn't. That'd be a real dark turn for this character. I mean, I really got nothing. I'll step up a little bit. For a second. Oh, jeez.
Ethan.
Speaking of bottlenecks.
Yeah, I'll just hang out right here.
All right.
Just pat Green Aurelian is dead.
Nyrelion, it is your turn.
He just stepped away.
No. Ah. All right, he doesn't do anything.
Cool, not his turn.
He's got. At this point, Nyrelion's just like standing in that fighting animation.
Like, oh no, he's buffering too. As like Volette's also doing the same.
Oh no!
I like the thing. Volette's just like walking into the wall, just boom.
Oh no, he's stuck in that loop again.
Oh dear.
Oh, this is a terrible time for that to happen. He just, like, puts, like, the Rancier just disappears, and then he goes into eating animation.
Yeah, come back, guys.
There he is.
Suddenly, weapon appears.
Yeah. Whose turn is it?
It's
you,
yours.
It is your turn.
Oh, it's
you literally, you left, and the split second later, we're like, and it's Nyrelion's turn.
Can I reach Blue with the main store from here?
You cannot. He does have cover from you. Around that wall.
Just bend it over your knee real quick and then...
What type of action is it to, like, exchange the Rancor for my sword?
I think you can just drop it.
Yeah, you can... It was... Yeah, you basically... Are you stowing it or just dropping the Rancor?
Can I, like, drop it, but, like, nicely so it, like, leans up against the wall and not, like, clatters to the ground?
Yeah, go ahead and roll dexterity for that.
you're gonna spike it.
Put it back into the statue's hands.
No, I just want to like set it against the wall so it doesn't like clatter down.
Nat one spikes it into the ground.
11.
Yeah, you managed to get leaned up against the wall real quick.
Cool. And then I will move, draw my sword, step onto green here, and
squish,
and. Cut Blue. How's Blue looking?
Real bad.
All right. I will not do a power attack.
Fist mark in its face. And a huge slash out the front.
Yep.
22 to hit?
22 will hit.
Cool. That will be... That wasn't an actual roll. I literally just dropped a d4 on the mat and it landed on exactly what it was like oriented towards. Okay, 2 + 4, so 6 + 4 = 10 damage.
Okay. Yeah, you slash this thing down, hitting it from the shoulder, cutting straight through it and through part of its, the like jaw tentacle. Oh, I don't know what to call
mandible.
It.
Mandible.
Cutting straight through that and about halfway to its chest, and it drops dead.
Well, that went well.
Ow, 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 ow.
Oh, are you okay,
Squeak? Squeak, are you okay?
It hit me! Aiden, does this look bad?
Yeah, let me take a look.
I'm going to dismiss the tower shield and go back to laser torch and...
Okay.
Move out of the way so he can move through.
I have a +1 to this.
Oops.
If you describe the wound, maybe I can assist you.
Ooh, I got a 3. Well, it's there, it's large, it's bleeding, it looks
here,
like.
Let me take a look. It appears to be some kind of injury.
Remind me to never get hurt around any of you.
Right. Listen, I can heal you if you'd like.
No, it's...
I just looks like a little bit of a scratch. It'll be fine.
I'm sure we can find some dirt to rub in it.
That seems like a bad idea.
Do you want me to have a panic attack? Don't rub dirt in it, please.
Well, it would be clean fine. Dirt.
There's sand.
That's just
going to get some sand.
Aiden.
Okay.
Whoa, it's dark over there.
Oh, no.
Yeah, the roll 20 tool doesn't like to...
It's spreading!
No! Run, Philip! Run!
I can see so well!
I'm consumed by darkness!
Run away, it's coming!
The roll 20 tool likes me to select the reveal tool and then hide.
You shouldn't have taken the Rancor!
Oh, speaking of which, I'm gonna go back and grab that.
Yeah, you got it. So you see, this platform is about 10 feet above the ground. Cells are all on the bottom floor, and the platform and boardwalk continue at that 10-foot height off into a side hallway.
Is there anything in good any of question. The cells?
Yeah.
Roll perception.
Yeah.
13. 7.
The only thing you really see in them is some of the cells have very, very old bones.
28.
Is there...
Your pain has given you clarity.
Yeah, there's still...
I see.
I'm looking for band-aids.
Yeah, you're not going to find any of that here. It's just bones.
There's strips of old cloth over here.
Well, based on the bones, can I tell how old they've been down? How long they've been down here for?
Go ahead and roll me. I'll say it's heal.
Heal? Thank you. Fine, sir. I can do math. 25.
Only considering 25? How dry these bones are, looking at them, you can kind of tell they're very old. Definitely more than a couple hundred years. Because at this point, everything, there is no organic matter other than the bones left. And they're dry, brittle.
All right. Really old.
That's
yeah.
Maybe revelation. Next time we go up, we should ask, like, if there was another town, like, built on top of this one or something.
Like the old one sank into a swamp or something like that?
I don't know. This is, like, this is old.
Well, I mean, there's the old light, so...
Oh, that
I think that's light. Older than the town, right? I mean, I don't know much about it, but you don't just call it the old light for nothing.
Yeah, that's true.
Well, worth looking into.
They're relatively newish light, but not that new.
Newly refurbished light.
New and improved light.
Historical landmark light.
That's right. No, the Sandpoint Heritage Site.
Yeah, the UNESCO World Heritage
Site. Yeah, yeah. Well, I mean,
some things
we've got...
I've read. Oh, before Varizia, there was another civilization here.
Huh. Really?
Could be from that.
All right, are we... Volette? Oh, damn, I left her in the hallway.
Oh, yeah. Don't let her wander off.
Go grab her.
Do we want to go back down one of the halls back there, or do we want to keep traveling this way?
I mean, I think there was just the one other hallway and then the stairs that went up.
Right.
I mean, we could keep going this way. One way's as good as another right now, right?
Yeah. Probably... I would say probably better to clear it, like, shallow end first, so, like, the hallways as we encounter them, rather than pushing all the way through and then clearing it all the way back out. That way, if there is something down one of those hallways, it can't, like, follow us and, like, get behind us.
That would be bad.
Be terrible, especially if we're running from something.
Well, okay. All right, let's go back. I'm concerned about us getting funneled into another situation like this, because this was... Oh, that was scary.
I don't know, it kind of seems like it's bound to happen. These hallways are just not suited for fighting. Or rather, I suppose they are suited for fighting.
I'll go behind Thea, that way I can use the...
I'll switch back to the spiked charge wall.
Oh, alright.
But that's the problem, see? So then that blocks out, like, here's the thing. I can't do anything.
And also, no one can see around that shield.
We can't see.
It might be better to try to push into the rooms.
Okay, I will switch back to the laser torch.
Okay.
Oh, alright.
Form up, squad. It's tea time.
Crazy eyes, roll out.
Oh, well, I can't join this group then. I guess I'll go back up the other way.
It's okay, we accept on crazy eyes.
So, heading down this way.
Normalize are crazy by association.
Party?
That's right, actually. Just having normal eyes makes them crazy in the present company.
So then I guess we will take the lead. Crazy eyes party commence. Oh boy.
That seems good.
That's a strange shaped room.
Alright, so...
Like an altar.
Oh boy. Someone
the tunnel widens here into what appears to be once been a small shrine. To the northeast, stairs lead... So steps lead up to the platform and what was once a small altar. It is a little more than jagged block of black marble with a shallow concavity on top of it. The basin is filled with what appears to be filthy water.
Somebody drink it.
All right, well,
a
hold
small
on.
Altar or a smalter, if you will.
Don't small anyone smalter. Touch anything. Every story I've ever heard, bad things happen when you touch altars.
Can we move it further into the room, please?
Yeah, could I have a look at it?
Same. How similar does this altar look like the altar I got cursed on?
Well, doesn't really look too much like it, other than it's all black.
Okay.
We perceive.
Jake, could I cast detect magic?
Yeah, could I take a look at this thing?
Go ahead. Go ahead and roll me perception, and then detect magic.
Can I like roll a religion check to see if I know anything about this? Whatever, like.
Angry altar, red lady with a spear and a book. Black altars.
Yeah.
Ransu, not spear.
That's a ransu, but a long spear.
It's just a spear with some plus. Extra bits.
Yeah.
Spear plus. I like that.
Well, no, it's closer to a trident if you want to, like. Never
mind. And a trident is just a spear with some extra bits on
it's
it.
Just spear times three.
That's right. Triple spear.
Really, every weapon is just some variation on the spear.
You're exactly right. Arrows, small projectile spears.
Sword? Spear that's all point.
Spear with a very long blade and short handle.
Dagger? Short much smaller spear.
Exactly.
It's just a spear without the shaft.
Hammer? Blunt spear.
Hand?
Human spear.
Knife hand.
Meat
and
spear.
Knives are spear.
Meat spear.
Which sounds horrifying. I will make an attack with my plus one meat spear.
Oh my God. I'm suddenly.
I hit him with my meat spear.
Which also sounds not great.
24 to
yeah, you're not wrong.
I'll help.
Oh my gosh. Got a 13.
I helped.
Yay!
I got a 24, so I helped.
Nice.
Alright, so. Looking at this altar, definitely very old, but well polished and very clean. The basin does have some dirty water in it. And you see down at the bottom some sort of symbol at the bottom of the bowl.
The bowl's on top of the altar?
Any magic?
It's a concave hole.
Oh, sorry. So the altar is down low.
Yeah, it's a basin.
Oh, okay. When you say
rolling blood and such.
When you say dirty water, do you mean like dirty with like scum, algae, dust, or is it like brown, mysterious, but has something mixed in with it?
Yeah, I didn't hear scum. I heard gum. Like,
I mean that too. You know, are there coins in the bottom of it?
It's a wishing well.
It's like the bottom of a New York City subway rail down here.
Hell yeah.
There's just loose pocket change and like fast food wrappers.
Does it look like a stagnant pool, or does it look like something an alligator might like climb out?
A very tiny alligator.
Don't see any algae or anything in it. It's definitely like, it's sort of like this dark brownish blackish haze in the water. It's not clear, but it's not. You don't see the physical like bits of stuff in it.
No bits.
You do see at the bottom of the bowl, the symbol that you see kind of looks like a three-eyed jackal.
Ooh. Ooh. That sounds like a religion check waiting to happen.
Go ahead and roll religion.
Nyrelion, you
did detect magic, right?
Detect magic, yeah.
You're detecting conjuration from these waters.
Okay. Can I... make,
well,
like, a knowledge or knowledge check to see if I, like, could recognize what this could be.
Go ahead.
Got a 13 on that religion check, because I can't roll higher than a 5 on these things.
I got a 12.
Dice, man.
Yeah, neither of you are certain. You know, Tuff, it's some sort of evil deity. This symbol kind of looks familiar. You might have seen it at one point. You can't place a name or anything.
Well, I don't know what it is, but it's definitely evil.
Tis the noble three-eyed
Nyrelion, you're not
jackal.
Quite sure what these Watto's are, but they are magical.
There's definitely something magical going on here. I'm getting a conjuration aura off of the water.
Well, I don't know what that means, but it doesn't sound good.
It doesn't sound good.
No, it's. I'm telling you. This three-eyed jackal thing, it's evil.
Generally tied to somebody.
That water does not look right.
Who votes to leave it alone?
Is there something we could
the lack
do
of hands
to...
being up.
Volette
is
going to raise her hand too.
Yeah, I'll put your hand up and raise it for her.
Hey, could I?
Majority wants to leave. Goodbye. Okay. But I didn't...
Oh, here's something I could do. I'll ask the group before I do it. I could cast Purify Food and Drink just to see what happens. It could be. It's kind of a toss up, but it could fix something.
Does it need to be fixed? Is there any reason we need to go down in there?
I mean,
will doing this spell prevent you from healing anyone else?
Oh no,
it looks like a block of rock in a nasty pool. I don't really see a reason to have to do anything.
Well, I think Jake, correct me if I'm wrong. The nasty pool is on top of the rock, right?
No,
it is. Yes.
Oh,
so it's a block of black marble. The top is completely flat, except there's a bowl carved into it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I thought you were saying the water was in the bottom of the, like, basin.
Oh, yeah, no.
Like, surrounding it. Like, why would we need to go down there?
I mean, in my experience, it's sometimes better just to...
I don't know. It still doesn't change
whatever
anything.
Whatever evil energies are... It's... I'd be more comfortable doing it, but I thought I'd ask.
I mean, this is well out of my area of expertise, so do what you think is best.
Okay, I'll stand behind him and just be like, if anything pops out, I'll try to help you.
Okay, we've got Squeak's vote. Anybody else want to chime in?
I don't
Trent,
care
you're against it.
I mean,
okay.
I don't know anything about magic, so...
Also, I'm kind of interested to see what happens.
And I don't like that.
Sure. Ethan, you go do it.
Ethan nervous.
Ethan, whatever your name is.
Ethan.
Go poke that water.
I'm going to keep Detect Magic up while he does this. And like watch the aura, see if it changes at all.
Yeah, Jake, I guess I'm going to... I guess we've got two votes for Theo. Do you have a preference here? Is there anything you'd like to add to the conversation?
He's like almost dissociating, like staring at the thing. Like you can see the cogs turning, like he's trying to remember something, but he's not responding to you.
Everything all right over there?
Hmm?
You look a little bit preoccupied.
Right.
Something feels familiar, I just can't put my finger on it.
Oh no, don't touch it.
Don't touch it.
I don't know, you could get a cool
curse?
Raccoon out of it or something.
Or a
I
curse.
Don't know if I want to.
I think
the
raccoon
like
is a curse.
Of the dice.
Don't say that too loud. You don't want him to hear
no,
him.
He.
See the muscles on that.
Theo,
thing.
You said the raccoon was a curse, right?
Theo. I'd touch his shoulder, but I'm scared that the hand will kill me.
Maybe we just leave him to his own devices for now.
No, it's past.
You're
I don't
friends
know.
With him. Touch his shoulder.
Well, what's the verdict?
Do what you're gonna do, I guess.
If you don't want to, I can.
Oh, here we go.
Pale Christ. I mean, Pale
that was
Christ.
It. That was the tree. No, I could do this.
I got it.
Yeah. Okay. Well, no. It sounds like we're more for it than against it, so. Yeah, I'll just cast Purify Food and Drink on this dirty, gross water.
Be the first to drink the water, Theo.
Well, it's the only way to know if it worked or not, right?
Yeah.
That's hard.
Oh, dear. Don't do that.
Hey, why not?
They're goading you.
I've already summoned a combat mug.
He's a child. Remember, he's 9 years old.
Oh, when you put it that way, you should definitely go first.
After read something, because the wording is ambiguous.
Perhaps you'd like to play with razor blades next.
I actively do constantly. That's like my whole power set.
Oh, I know.
So how about them Yankees? I don't know if they're doing well. I don't follow baseball.
I think they're playing baseball still.
Do they do that? I thought they switched to soccer.
That would be interesting.
I mean, only baseball team I follow is the Savannah Bananas.
Yeah. Is that a thing?
So you cast purify food and water on this basin. And the water clears up.
I'll scoop it up.
What do you do?
What happens to the magical aura when he does that?
It disappears.
Really?
That's either good or bad.
The conjuration aura is gone.
Mission accomplished, then? Perhaps?
All right, well, then I guess we just...
You do feel...
Oh, God.
Let me see.
You feel the cold hand of death on your shoulder.
I would like to point out that I am not in the basin.
You feel
the last breath of your life exhale from you.
You feel most of the conjuration magic leave the water. The altar itself, you still get like a very slight conjuration sense from.
There is still something with the altar. The water is fine now, but the altar is still...
Maybe the altar is what changed the water? Maybe.
That's possible.
I don't know anything about magic, but...
Does that sound possible?
Go ahead and roll Knowledge Arcana.
23,
okay. With that, you know there's two possibilities. Either this turns water that's put into it into whatever it was,
mm-hmm.
or it generates it.
Okay, so either water that goes into this gets turned into whatever that was, or the altar actually generates that water of its own right. So if we were to empty it, it could theoretically refill.
So it's just like a filthy water fountain.
What's a water fountain?
Well, they had fountains back then. They just didn't.
Oh, I thought you meant like a drinking fountain. No.
No. Yeah. Seems like an odd thing to design.
What is a drinking fountain?
Is that a fountain you can drink from? I mean,
it's every fountain ever.
For any fountain,
could they fill a fountain with chocolate?
Ooh. Or cheese.
Cheese.
Just, you know, as a non-specific kind of thing.
Or tea. Tea could be fun.
Tea.
Well, we could always come back to it later, I suppose. See what the water what the water does.
I am going to drink the purified water I pulled out. Just...
Oh, wait. Don't.
Oh my gosh.
It's too late now.
I failed the will save.
He's gonna...
Well.
Wait. I just had a thought. What if whatever in that water is what makes those creatures?
Everyone turns to Theo.
As he's like...
Oh, shit. Well, it was fun knowing ya.
What's another curse?
What's another curse?
Oh, my gosh. Now that's a t-shirt.
Here we go.
Speaking of, Justin, I still need to get that to you. I'll work on that this week.
Well, do we want to go through these double doors?
Wait, is he drinking the water or no?
Yes.
There we go.
Unless someone is actively stopping me, yes.
I might try to.
I might try to as well if I'm up there.
Grab your wrist. Like, hey,
yeah,
you
I'll
do
like...
That.
No, what are you doing?
Are you forcing your way through it, or are you going...
I'm going to go for it.
Okay,
gonna,
go ahead
gonna,
and roll.
I'm not going to resist him.
Oh my god.
Yeah, if you guys want to physically stop him, go ahead and roll grapple.
I'm not going to.
If you guys are letting him go, you can drink.
Yeah, no, it's. I mean, right. At the end of the day, it's your volition.
Have fun.
So you come up, you drink this water, which tastes like water.
Cool.
You're fine.
It's just water.
Right, well, I think we've spent enough time in this room. Maybe we should leave.
Forward.
Double door?
Double door.
And as you come up to these double doors, this is the first set of double doors you've seen in this entire complex. And it's fairly ornately carved and heftier than the other doors.
Push or pull?
Wrong perception.
Depends on how strong you are.
22.
22, okay.
Not that strong.
Quickly. So 22, you know it's a pull.
Okay. Well, there goes my chance to Aragorn it.
Just waiting for the push so you can kick it open.
Absolutely. Swing both doors open, I guess. Unless they're locked.
Nope, they're opened.
Yeah, whatever's going on down here, they don't lock their doors properly.
I'm fine with that, actually.
Yeah, so far it's worked out in our favor. That's just, you know, an oversight.
I would like to say, if I do, I am opening the doors with the full intention that if I see a creature, I'm going to charge it.
Yes. So you open these doors. And you see this room.
What in the world?
This huge room looks nothing more than an immense underground cathedral. Stone doors stand to either side of the main entrance, but beyond this, the walls are carved with strange, spiky runes. In the center of the room is a large pool with a ring of polished human skulls balanced on top stone spikes, arranged in a circle around the deeper midsection. At the far end of the room, a pair of stone stairways lead up to a pulpit, on which sits a second pool, this one triangular and filled with some sort of orange water. Heat, you can see wisps of what look like heat and steam rising from this strange pool, but the room itself feels deathly cold. And as you come in here, you see this small winged creature standing no more. Yeah, standing about a foot tall, fluttering above this pool. As you come in, she was watching the doorway. And as you come in, you see with just a scowl and shriek, she yells, "How dare you come into the Mother's Sanctum!" And with the silver dagger in her hand, will slash her hand and drop a few drops of blood into the pool.
Oh, no.
Oh, dear. Can't be good.
Oh, no.
That can't be good.
And you see from two things. Where did I put that? You see rising up out of the pool is another one of those creatures.
Great.
The glow of the pool does diminish a good bit when she does this.
Oh no, it's recharging.
Go ahead and roll initiative.
Ah!
Ooh.
And,
bad roll.
Oh, I did upload these.
Is the initiative tracker up?
Nope.
Hey, we can
Oops, maybe.
Reroll!
Reroll!
I'm okay with that.
Rolled again!
I'd rather not.
You can keep yours, but everybody else. Can we take advantage on her initiative roll?
All right, so this is what you see of the creature.
That doesn't look like a problem or anything.
Keeping in mind, it's about a foot tall.
Oh, it's a foot tall?
Nyrelion? Yeah. Oh, looks like we do have to reroll. Bummer.
Oh, bummer.
Hey.
Oh, crap.
Hey.
You know, I will say honestly, as the healer, I prefer going later anyway, so I'm good.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I'm totally fine with that.
My natural 20 from before.
No, it's cool. I like going last.
That's actually where I prefer to be.
I don't know what you assholes are all about. The last is where it's at.
Actually, I'm going to, like, hold my turn to go last. I'm going to change my turn order.
If you think about it, last, you're just first at the end of the round.
Although, when you think about it, like, first really only matters in the first round.
It does.
Yeah, yeah. No, min damage is cool. I like min damage. It just means I get to fight more stuff.
It means I get to roll dice more.
Yeah.
You know what I really think? Combat, not sloggy enough.
Yeah.
Well, no, it's cool. You know, being surrounded, it just means you can attack in any direction.
Yeah, exactly. No,
I do have a question.
Yes.
Do I get the charge that I said I was going to do if I saw a creature when I opened the door? Or am I stuck in the door until my turn?
I don't think legally you can make a charge.
Oh, more like just like a move towards it, but more asking what
you
wanted.
I'd say since you named it, yes.
Okay. No, wait, wait, there he goes.
There's no way to actually make
a if he dies, he dies. I guess. You're going straight through the pool?
How high up is this space right here? Like the edge of the altar.
Well, it's a big pool of water with spikes in it.
It's
like a 20-foot wide pool of water.
Oh, fuck. Never mind. I'll just go this way.
It's 15. You can jump that.
Yeah, 15.
You can jump that.
I for sure cannot.
Oh, wait. Yeah, wait. I could jump that.
Yeah, you probably could easily.
I am not a dex build. I am in medium armor. I have no ranks.
And you just sink if you got stuck in there.
And there goes Theodahad.
Dips on his loot.
Should have been wearing his wetsuit.
Right. You're up.
He died like he lived, forgetting that he owned that wetsuit. Sorry, Justin.
Okay, it's in the car.
Oh, man. Sorry. Did you say me?
Yeah, you first.
Yes.
All right. I was joking about the reroll. If you want us to use our previous rolls, that's fine.
Yeah, that'd be just dandy.
We all have the new rolls in right now, though, so...
Mm-hmm.
I'm actually gonna run. I'm gonna do a thing. I'm gonna try to use my brain. I'm gonna run to here. And as part of my move, I'm going to pull out my short bow.
Oh, that would be a good idea.
And I'm going to attack the little flying creature, I guess. It can make other creatures, so it seems like a bigger threat. Yuck. 13. So that's a no.
That is definitely a no.
All right. Joop. That's one arrow gone. All right, that's my turn.
I could take my whole turn and get right up next to it, but I feel like that's a really bad idea.
Don't do that.
Don't do that.
Yeah. So I...
You'll give it a full attack action.
Ted. Yeah. Oh, God. I don't know what to do. Hold on. I'm just going to do... Son of a bitch. I can't do that because... I'll just move into the room.
I mean, if you really want to...
This is as far... That's 30.
If you... Since this thing is flying, I'm... Ranged might be the way that we're going to have to hurt it. Or at least...
How high up is it flying right now?
I can't help you. Then I can't do anything.
No, no, but I was saying if you aided me and gave me a plus 3...
I have to be within melee of it.
Okay.
Yeah. I can't, yeah.
Right.
Can't be your spotter.
Nope.
Dang it.
Unfortunately, I wish it was like
right.
that.
Right, right, yeah. I forgot that a little bit.
Can I pass something off to someone?
Yeah, you can pass something to someone.
If I pass you, I can give you a healing potion.
Yeah, yeah.
I will run into the room. I will hand the healing potion to Trent, and I will say, good luck. I'm gonna pop right up behind him. I will follow him in.
Good luck.
You're responsible. You said you have kids, but Ted were like yours.
I gain 2 temporary levels as
dad mode activated.
Dad mode has activated.
Oh my gosh. You said the magic words.
I pick up a car.
Wrestle a grizzly bear with your bare hands.
That's right. Yeah. Just yelling, those are my kids!
You're fucked. You really pissed off dad.
My dad's gonna beat you up.
Dad. My dad's gonna beat up your dad.
That's right. My dad can beat up your dad.
My dad's the CEO of Nintendo. I've heard so many kids do that. My dad runs Nintendo. Sure. Sure, kid. Dumbass.
Like, I don't... That's when you're like, I don't think he's gonna win a fight. Like, I'm less convinced now that he's gonna win a fight.
I wasn't talking about a Super Smash Brothers fight.
Just, yeah, the ultimate response to that is, well, he sounds like a nerd.
It's like, oh, so this is gonna be easy.
Tell him to get his fucking pocket protector ready, because he's about to get his head swirly.
Hope he's got an extra pair of underwear, because those are getting wedgied.
That must mean he has a lot of lunch money.
Nice. Alright, so bad guy doesn't take its turn. Nyrelion.
Does. I had to look up. Alright, so...
Oh, gosh.
She stays where she is. Actually, she flies up... So yeah, she'll... staying where she is, 10 feet above the pool. You see she begins casting a spell.
Uh-oh. That's
That is her turn.
Oh.
Not good.
That's a summoning spell right there.
Uh-oh.
Hopefully. What else can...
Nyrelion.
It takes more than one round to cast is a good thing.
I mean, I don't know magic.
Okay, I'm going to move 20 feet in to there. And then my internet is going to drop out momentarily.
So is mine.
No, it's your internet.
It's my internet.
Oh, okay, because
I'm running the bot, so the bot's...
Ah, so disco.
Yep. God, what is happening?
It sounds kind of like music.
Hold on, let me just kill it real quick.
It's called lag synth. It's a new music style.
Yeah, I've listened to a lot of avant-garde compositions. That's a new one.
It's a new variation on like.
There we go. Okay.
Honestly, it just feels a little bit like industrial punk. Which you laugh, but that's an actual genre.
Yep. Yep.
And then I'm going to, as part of that move action, I'm going to draw my sword. I'm then going to reach into a relatively large-looking pouch on my belt and pull out a literal fistful of salt.
Bucket sand.
As in, like, a fifth of a pound of salt.
Pocket salt.
Can you fit that in one hand?
I hope so.
He's got big hands.
You should be able to. That's not too bad.
Aim my sword forward at the thing that just got out of the pool. So not the lady, but the thing we've been fighting. Say a few words in a language, and the salt like flows out of my hand and like spirals around the blade of the sword, transforming into this like greenish blackish energy, and then lances towards this abomination as I cast Ray of Enfeeblement.
Ooh.
using salt as an alchemical power component.
Hell yeah. I love alchemical power components.
They're wonderful.
What if it's like a block of salt? Not table salt.
Like a crystal?
Like a block.
A block of... That would make more sense.
Also, salt is hella dense. I just looked it up. So, it's not a lot.
Oh, okay. Sweet. But yeah, so I need to make an attack roll to hit this thing's touch AC. Does a 15 hit this thing's touch AC?
Touch, definitely, yeah.
Okay. And then it needs to make a DC 16 saving throw.
Of what variety?
I'm looking it up because I totally forgot. I believe it's con. Fortitude. Fortitude saving throw.
That is a fail.
Sweet. Okay, so then it is going to take a 4 penalty to its strength score.
Ooh.
So its strength score will be lowered by 4.
Okay.
Get wrecked.
And that will last for...
Until it dies.
2 rounds.
Oh, never mind.
Okay. Two markers on it.
And that is my turn.
And that, they dad.
Alright. All the way up. I never changed from combat mug. So... It's statistically exactly the same as my Morningstar. Like it's a light mace, so they deal similar damage. But I'm gonna attack with my Cold Iron Morningstar, I think, for now. Does a 21 hit?
21 will hit.
How big did we say that lip was?
Like the 10 feet up.
10 feet up.
Where the fuck is my D8?
Other quick question, is this an occupiable space or no? Oh, you can't see my marker, hold on.
Hell yeah. 11 points of bludgeoning and piercing damage.
Nice.
And then my hand is going to take its full round action to make a single attack. With the mace as well. So just a backhand. Dirty 20.
That'll hit.
And then that's another 9 points of bludgeoning and piercing.
Okay, this thing is really not looking good. Edan.
Who?
Yeah, who?
Okay, Edan.
There's this guy who's been following us around. I think his name's Eric or something.
Edan?
I'm not gonna lie. You wrote the name for the creature right there, and I just thought it was you continuing the joke.
That would have been great.
Well. Yes, another one.
I think what I'm going to do this time... I bought the thing I might as well get my money's with. I'm going to load the crossbow as a move action. Line it up. Pew! Right at... this one.
Yeah!
Okay. This die has let me down a lot today. This is your chance.
To do it again.
Oh, sweet. Okay, 19.
Nice. 19. What is the range on the crossbow?
80 feet. So it's got
80 feet. Okay, cool.
Plenty of range, yeah.
Nice.
What did you roll?
19.
You hit.
Please. I hope she fails the concentration check.
Oh, that would be really nice. Let's see here.
That makes more sense now. Okay, I didn't understand how concentration checks work before, but now I'm starting to think. Okay. As long as
they're
in the process of casting a spell.
Yeah, if they're...
while they're casting it.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
Which is nice for summoning spells to counter them, because you basically everyone gets a full round to try to interrupt it. Mm-hmm. Because it takes a full round.
Gotcha.
Instead of a full action.
Yeah.
Which is why Janus would always turn invisible before doing so.
Yes.
Oh my god. Okay.
Mm-hmm. So that no one could interrupt him.
Yeah.
So 3 damage. It's not great, but...
3, okay. Let's see. That oh yeah, one... definitely made it.
Oh.
Wow.
Damn.
I tried.
How high up is it?
Is the thing flying?
You actually, Edan, you shoot your crossbow at this thing and it definitely hits it. But the crossbow clatters to the ground.
The crossbow?
The bolt?
No, crossbow bolt.
Okay. So it didn't do any damage? Like, it doesn't look like it hurt?
No, doesn't look like it hurt her at all.
Well, shit.
How high up is it?
I'm just gonna...
sold me a bad crossbow!
I'm just gonna toss the crossbow on the ground. 10
feet. Yes.
Okay.
Oh, so...
So wait, so could a creature standing underneath her reach her, or no? Is she in the square 10 foot up, or is she, like... Is there 10 feet below her?
So, like, if I were to... run to here, could I hit, or would I have to be right underneath?
You would have to be directly underneath.
Dang it.
But if you were directly underneath, you could hit her.
Yes.
Okay.
That's my turn, though. That's all I got.
Right. With that, this creature is going to go and do a full attack action against Theodahad. Going for the two claws first. What's your AC?
18.
Those aren't going to hit, and that's going to go in for a bite.
Man, Jake, you've been rolling some serious junk tonight.
Yeah, that one does hit.
Hell yeah.
Okay, here we go.
I have a feeling these bites have got some nasty side effects.
Yeah, you take... 3 damage. Then I need a will save.
Strength penalty!
Oh, no, that's not good.
Oh.
Is that 3 damage with the strength penalty?
Was the attack with the strength penalty?
Was the attack with the strength penalty?
Attack, yes.
Damage?
Damage.
Minus 2.
Okay, damage was 1.
You still gotta make a will save, though, which is...
Yep.
Fire dice.
That's gonna succeed.
Nice.
I'm a little disappointed, but I'm very excited.
Yeah, you get bitten by this thing. And for a very brief second, your mind just fills with just this contemptuous rage for almost everything. But you're quickly able to shove it aside and stay as you are. With that, Trent.
Okay. Step to here. I'm assuming I can still see the flying creature.
Yes.
And I'm going to take another shot with my bow.
All right.
You know, I honestly can't tell if that's a 9 or a 6.
What's on the opposite side?
Oh, wait. No, it's a 9. It's a 9. I see the little line under it now.
That's good. That's better.
Yeah, 15's probably still not going to hit.
Unfortunately, does not.
Okay. That's my turn.
All right. Squeak.
Okay. I kind of want to get to here.
Also, I've got to leave really soon. So if you guys want to continue having Trent help you.
Yeah, no. I mean, what would it take for me to hop off the wall? I want to hit the spot.
That would require a climb check.
Okay. I'll do that. Natural 20.
Okay. Oh. Yeah, you make it.
Doink. Does that also give me enough to hit, or no?
Unfortunately not.
Nope. Cool. I am here.
Yeah. When you climb, you climb at the half
spawn. Hit the other thing.
The what?
The sin spawn is
right between you and me.
That's what I asked. If I could hit it, and you said no.
You have 30 feet of movement, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, you're climbing up.
10 feet.
I guess that's 5 feet. So yeah, that would be.
15.
Okay, yeah.
Because climb counts as double, so.
So would that hit it for 30?
But you would
that would be 30 if you move from there. Yes.
Yeah. So.
So yes,
I can.
You can.
Hit?
Okay. Yep.
Right. 26.
Don't forget your flanking.
Oof.
26 does hit.
28.
Unfortunately, 29 doesn't make it.
Oh,
God.
It has a reverse AC.
It's gotcha. Two.
Yep.
How much?
2.
Okay, this thing is still up.
That's my turn.
All right. You see this creature finishing its spell. Nyrelion. Right in front of you. Of a token.
Is it anybody else, or does this evil altar thing look kind of like a Dorito?
It looks like a Dorito.
It's a definitely pool.
It's a Dorito of summoning. It's an evil summoning Dorito.
the Dorito of evil.
Vaguely looks like the same shape as Captain America's back. I just realized that is a very hyper-specific Tumblr reference.
Okay, got that uploaded. So you see appearing right in front of you, Nyrelion. Size this. Okay.
Of course.
This massive spider, about your size, that appears right racist. In front of you. And it's going to attack you.
Hello there.
Oh, God.
What's your AC?
My AC is 16.
That is going to hit.
Not a crit, though, right?
Nope, not a crit. You're going to take...
You know what? Fuck it. I'm going to cast Windy Escape. So I'll get DR10 against this.
Okay, so you negate all the damage... but I'm going to need
I'm also immune to any poison, sneak attacks, or critical hit effects.
Okay. Never mind. Nothing happens.
As I just, like, kind of, like, turn incorporeal for a second, and it, like, phases through.
Jeez.
With that, Aurelian's going to fly up over the pool here.
Don't like that.
And guys are dealing with that.
Does that provoke an attack of opportunity from Squeak?
I think it's too low down.
No, if it flew straight over you, then
you would get it if it flew straight over you.
No, she has room to maneuver around, or movement speed to maneuver around.
Man, we really needed Volette here to cast Daze.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Or something to knock her out of the air.
He's going to cast this on Trent.
Nope. I have a thing that says she can't. She's not allowed to.
It's called plot armor.
Yeah.
He paid 1,000,000 gold for it.
Yep.
Yeah, well, unfortunately, she also has the spell... I don't know, what spell, weapon? She is armor piercing.
What?
Plot armor piercing.
Plot armor piercing.
Oh.
Plot armor piercing.
Plot armor piercing. Oh, no.
So you... She's I'm gonna FMPs. Need a... will save.
Alright. Ten even.
That is not enough, as you see her, you see how she flits around and your vision goes blurry for a second, and you're just hit with this incredible wave of exhaustion as you slowly fade to unconsciousness.
Okay.
Sleep.
All right, well, I guess, see you guys.
It is exactly 10 o'clock.
Yeah,
I gotta go. Be safe on the road.
Drive safe, man.
Will do.
Catch you later.
Your computer won't go to sleep, will it?
No. Oh. Nope. I already had it set, so I'm gonna...
Sweet.
Camera off, and... there we go. All right. Have fun, guys.
Drive safe. All
right. See ya.
How long do you guys intend on going?
It'll be after this fight, and then we're ending.
Got it. Okay. All right, yeah. Have a good night, guys.
All right. Good night.
Good night.
Nyrelion, your turn.
Yeah, I think it's kind of time to attack this spider fucker.
Wait, what did it do to a spider?
I mean, it's a spider, well, so it kind of makes sense.
I guess that's true. Daddy spider. Yeah. Love each other very much.
It's like calling your dad motherfucker.
And he just goes, uh-huh. And you're like,
you're welcome.
I'm gonna go ahead and do a power attack.
Okay.
Nat 20.
Oh
boy. Okay.
Here it is.
I don't think this thing's gonna survive.
Well, I've rolled 2 ones so far.
Oh, this thing might survive.
5, 7 plus 7, 14. That's a really low. Oh wait, no, not 14. Set plus 7 again. 21.
Oh, it's a x3 crit.
No, it's a x2, but my modifier is plus 7, so that gets multiplied. So it's 14 plus, yes, and then 7 on the roll of 4 dice.
We have a problem.
21.
The one who's down has the healing potion.
Yeah, this one, the spider immediately dies and then dissipates.
Where's the other one? Nyrelion has it, right?
I have it.
Okay, good.
Good.
Are you moving at all, or?
Yeah, I'll skirt around to, like, here.
Okay. Hey, Dad. It's your turn.
Okay. I am gonna look at the flying. I'm guessing probably imp, but that's probably not right. That's causing most of our problems right now. I need enough. How high up is she right now from like the flat space right here? Like vertical distance, I can figure out.
Vertical distance, 15 feet.
Would it be 20? She was 10 feet up on the platform.
She flew down slightly.
15, doable.
Okay, I can do that. I'm going to take the attack of opportunity for running past the sin spawn. I'm going to use my swift action to do my one-a-day spell-like ability, Cheetah's Sprint, which for having a movement speed above 30,
I know exactly what you're doing.
Plus 68 to my acrobatics check. It's a plus 4 for every 10 feet above 30.
Yep.
200 feet is a plus 64, which brings my acrobatics total to 71 bonus. I know, it's truly stupid.
What the hell is going on?
Cheetah Sprint is a ridiculous spell.
Sam, Justin.
That's not even hard. Literally any first level druid can do this.
Yeah.
Wait, is that what you are?
God, no. I'm a two levels of fighter. I just get... I'm also have fairy blood, so...
I don't understand this game enough just as it is. This is absolute lunacy. What the fuck?
Yeah, so I'm going to run this way. I'm going to take the drop down onto the ground so I can get my 10 foot of a running jump. So I can fully make it to here as part of a charge. I'm going to jump up and grapple her.
Okay. Go ahead and roll to grapple.
Would you like me to roll my acrobatics check to jump?
Yes. I doubt you're going... Actually, you're not going to fail.
16 plus 71 is...
An 80...
87.
Sorry, 87. It's a DC 88.
Oh,
I did the math. It's with a running jump, my long jump is equal to my roll in feet, and it's equal to 1/4 my roll in vertical height. I can beat it with the rolling a 1 for both distances.
Yeah, you make it.
Cool. I'm praying to God that her CMD is
bad
because she's a caster.
Caster. Yeah.
She
also
is tiny,
also
though,
tiny
so.
Too.
But it's okay.
A bonus or a minus on grapples?
I forget. I think it's actually a minus. Yeah.
I think it is.
It's a minus from size. Yeah.
It's grabber.
Where's my CMB combat maneuver plus 5? Okay, that is a 19.
Okay. Yeah, you quickly, you're able to do it. You quickly snatch her out of the air, coming back down, landing, and she is in
your
hands.
I'd like to try and aim for the spikes.
Make an attack
also,
roll.
Did he take the attack of opportunity?
I also get the sin spawn. Also takes the attack of opportunity prior to this, so we might want to resolve that first.
Sin spawn rolled a natural 2.
Yeah, Jake, you could roll like ass.
Yeah, you could roll like terribly, man.
I'm sorry.
I promise this is a harder encounter.
That requires you to roll well.
Yeah. Or decent.
That's a 7 for attacking with the spike.
No, you missed the spike.
Okay. So where do we land and do we still take fall damage?
You will take fall damage.
Both of us?
Just you, since you're holding her.
Okay.
And you missed the spike.
That's fine.
You take 1 point bludgeoning.
Okay. I'm assuming we're like, honestly, probably like here. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, because you would have moved forward.
Yeah.
Moved over the spike. Yeah. So how much did you say?
You take 1 point bludgeoning.
Oh, okay. No problem.
And you have her grappled.
Cool. I would like to have my hand take its four-round action to use its spiked masterwork gauntlet to punch her in the face while I hold her underwater.
Okay. Go ahead and roll to attack.
That would be a natural 2 plus 5 plus 4 is 6.
Wait, no, that's not plus
five. So 7. Sorry.
Yeah, it's missed.
It's okay. It's the light change with the water. I like swift. Like I punch out of the water in.
What square is she in?
Her and Justin currently are in the same square.
Okay.
And I am on top of her, holding her down.
Yes.
In the least creepy way possible to kill her.
Nah, you're already killing her. Why stop at creepy?
Yeah, and she's underwater currently.
Can't cast spells underwater.
Edan, it is your turn.
All right. Nope. I gotta check on something here. So, I've got a couple weird questions now that things have changed a little bit. First weird question, would it take an action to close the doors?
Yes. There are two big doors. It would take an action.
I'm assuming I'm dragging with her. It's going to take an action. Okay. So that may begs that. No, it's not worth it. Never mind. I'm not going to debate this. Second question, if I get up to the pool, Could I theoretically stick my hands where Theo's hands are, roughly just a little bit above them, and cast color spray into this water?
There might be some backlash because of the water, but it's possible. You're not sure how it would reflect or refract, but it might work.
Okay. Well, yeah, I'm not gonna do that then.
You got shocking grasp?
I am an oracle. Nobody has taken a... Well, one person has taken a single wound so far.
I am at slightly above half damage, half hit points.
Oh.
I'm at 15 out of 26. I have not been full hit points the entire day.
Yeah. I'll just pat you on the shoulder. That is 5 health back.
Highest I've been all day. 20 out of 26.
It looks like you've got things well in hand. So, have at it, I guess. What a way to go.
Yeah.
How deep is this water?
Where you're currently standing, about 3 feet deep. It's difficult terrain. Okay.
But I'm mostly asking to make sure that I am not actively sinking into something too deep for me to swim out of.
You're not.
Okay.
With that, it is the spawn's turn. Grabbing new dice.
I was hoping to have someone up here with me. Fuck.
Sorry.
It's cool. It's cool.
Okay.
Shit. It's me rolling. Don't worry.
I know. And you said you switched dice. That's what I'm concerned about.
This is not my first time switching dice, so don't worry. Going for the 2 claw attacks.
With.
Yeah, really don't worry. Both miss.
Okay.
It still has the strength penalty until the beginning of my next turn.
Yep. And then going in for the bite attack. Damn, yeah, that misses.
Okay, never mind.
Nothing to worry about. These things
3,
suck.
6, 3. Oh.
Jesus.
Real bad.
Okay.
You're an honest man. More honest than I would be.
You're not all the way through this dungeon yet, so... Right, it is, Trent is unconscious.
Oh, yeah. Someone should probably deal with that. Make sure to choke on his tongue.
Yeah.
You hear him, soundly snoring.
That's not good.
Yeah, I'm gonna say, like, if I'm looking around and I see Trent down... Trent's down.
He's down.
Fuck. Okay, panic. I'm gonna just reach out. I'm just gonna...
That unfortunately does not hit.
Flurry of blows. That's a 19 on the die. That'll hit.
That'll hit.
Max damage, 7.
This thing had 2 hit points.
Oh my fucking god. She's gonna turn around and...
What is going on? Trent!
Take a look at Trent.
That's my turn. It's all I do.
Alright. So, Aurelium's going to try to escape the grapple, of course. And what is your CMD?
My CMD is 16.
Okay.
She's gonna have an absolutely shit CMD too.
Don't speak too soon. We don't know.
She made it.
Sorry.
Wait, girl!
She rolled a natural 16. But no, she gets out of the grapple and is going. She's going to eat the attack of opportunity and just fly straight up.
Where? Oh, straight up. Shit.
Yeah. So Theodahad, you get your attack of opportunity.
Okay, two questions. So did the round before count as her holding her breath for a round underwater?
It did.
Taking any action while you're holding your breath underwater counts as a full round in addition to whatever round you're in of holding your breath. And you can hold your breath for two rounds per point of constitution.
Let me see.
So more than likely she should have enough constitution, even if she has a shit constitution, to last two rounds plus pulling out.
Mm-hmm.
I said what I said.
Can't get away with anything with Sam in the house.
Sorry, I have the mind of a...
So yeah, it's... 13-year-old. Character takes the standard or full round action. Remaining duration that the character can hold her breath is reduced by one round. So it would reduce it, but she can still do it.
And she also has to make a DC 10 constitution check to continue holding her breath.
That's after her. It's a number of rounds
after
double.
Gotcha. Mm-hmm. Okay, so she's good. Never mind. I just wanted to make sure.
Yep.
So attack of opportunity.
Question.
Yeah.
Don't you get two since both you and your arm can make an attack of opportunity?
No. It requires a full round attack to make a single standard action attack.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So it's using its full action to make that one attack.
Gotcha.
It's fairly limited what it can do for right now. Level 3 changes that.
Gotcha.
Once I get the feat to make it an actual familiar.
Oh, gosh.
Oh, no.
No. It's another two.
You try to swing as she flies up and she... gets around your hand and flies straight up.
How high?
At 20 feet.
Does she also provoke an attack of opportunity from Edan?
Since you were sharing the same square, yes.
Do
you have any melee?
I can try to kick her.
Or grab her. You can make a grapple attempt.
Can you?
You can do any combat maneuver as part of it, like in place of an attack of opportunity.
I guess I'll try it. Yep. And combat maneuver. It's not going to be good. Where is my... I believe it's a plus 0. Because your CMB is your strength plus your BAB, right?
Yep.
Yeah. So plus 0. Yep. Well, okay. This dice did me well once so far. 13. That's not great.
That's not enough.
Can Rags, who is around my neck, get an attack of opportunity?
I'm going to say no.
That's fine.
But she can't do anything else this turn. With that, Nyrelion.
Okay.
So she's 20 feet up in the air right now.
Yes.
So there's not really anywhere in this room within, like, where you could stand where a 10-foot reach would get to her?
Unfortunately not.
Throw your sword at her.
Fingers you can crossed, technically work. Hit the downed Trent on the other side.
Just wham. Oh no.
Zach would come back next time. So we're sorry, but Trent died.
Trent, unfortunately.
You're never going to believe what happened.
Which monster killed me? Nyrelion.
We've already told him he's got to go back to remedial Jedi training.
He also feels really bad.
I'm reading a spell description.
Also, I was looking up for what I had to, like, do the purified food and drink with. I asked my question, and there's some concerning things on the purified food and drink questions list.
Oh, no.
Questions if you can turn seawater into fresh water.
Not a problem. That's not worrying.
That's not what he's looking at.
Poisons and diseases are removed. Question, it also removes its parasites, mold, and fungus, and other impurities. And then my ultimate favorite,
very
urine.
Gross question. Yep.
Is the spell just a Brita filter?
Basically, yeah. It's a magical Brita filter. It's a
magical Brita filter. Hey, put vodka as written, that would work. Awesome. That's amazing.
So yes, you can drink your own piss with purified food and drink water.
Dude, I'm set.
I know it's not even like purify, but like from the Eric Andre show, the turn that poop into wine. Turn that poop into wine. That's all I hear in my head. I don't
know why. Wait, so I guess you could purify food and drink urine and then use the spell water to wine.
Yeah.
You could do it. It's possible in Pathfinder.
Into wine.
Well, here's the question: does it change like anything about it other than the fact that it's unsanitary? Like,
yeah,
it's
technically,
but,
flavor is free, Jordan.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Like, isn't
it would still just
sterile?
Be...
No, it's
yeah,
not.
It's kind of a myth.
It's a myth.
It's a myth. Good to know.
Technically,
just like
when it's in
peeing
your body,
on stuff
kind of,
to cure it is a myth.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, no, not like that.
It's also not sterile, though.
Yeah.
It also tastes terrible. Don't recommend. I'm not saying I've ever done it. That is not okay, no.
Are you sure?
No,
that
was very authoritative.
No.
If you are ever in like a survival situation where you do need to conserve water, you want to boil it and then like strain or like let things settle. But like you don't want to just let things settle and then directly drink it because it's not actually sterile.
So don't Bear Grylls it.
Don't Bear Grylls it, yeah.
Bear Grylls had lemonade and we all know it. Bad liar.
Probably what you would actually want to do is let everything settle, decant off like the upper like layer without anything in it, like where it's clear. So decant that into a separate container and then boil that, because you wouldn't want to boil it while there was still minerals and stuff in it.
Or you boil it and then condense it onto something above it.
Well, yeah, you could distill it.
Watching,
if you distilled it, that would be fine. Yeah.
Yeah.
For anyone still watching, sorry.
Distill your
don't do that. Please don't do that.
Yes, please cut this out.
We didn't even get to the golden shower joke, so it's fine.
Oh my gosh.
Oh.
God damn it.
Oh, man.
Oh. That was good.
That was really good. Damn it.
How confident are you guys in your ability to do anything with this situation?
I have something.
But
it's something.
Should I pull out all the stops is what I'm asking.
We probably all should.
Here's the problem, though. Like, are we gonna rest here?
We have more dungeon is the thing.
I know.
Yeah.
We could see what her play is.
Well, we can't really know the play until we do it.
Everybody else first.
Yeah, I guess that's what I'm saying. We could just kind of wait around and half-ass it.
If you can hit her, hit her, because the guy with the bow is down. I can't do anything. Jess is out of action.
I can do a thing, but it would be quite resource-intensive and take two rounds.
Okay, here's another thing to think about. She might not be here in two rounds. We don't know if she's sticking around. That's why I was going to close that door.
I will run over and close the door.
Okay.
How high is the ceiling?
The ceiling is 40 feet up.
Okay.
Closing the door is my turn.
It does, like, dome, so the edges are maybe 30 feet, and then it goes up to the top. It arches.
40 at the apex.
40 at the apex.
Okay.
And then I'll actually be right back.
Okay.
They're dropping like flies.
No, no.
What are we doing?
They dad.
Fuck.
All right. I'm going to pull my composite shortbow off my back.
Finally.
I'm not a range build, so this is not... not going to be as good as...
Let's hope we don't have to worry about the fact that you're shooting directly above you.
Uh-huh. Oh, we're going to aim, shoot straight up. That first one is a 23 to hit.
Oh.
That'll hit.
That'll be 6 points of piercing damage.
All right. So you see you draw a bit of blood from her.
Cool. My hand is going to take its full round action to make a single attack.
Can it reach? She's 15 feet in the air, isn't she?
I'm going to fire my bow again.
Oh, sorry, no. Oh. Ceiling of this room is 20 feet high.
Oh, so she's
a lot shorter than I thought it was. Okay.
So she's at the ceiling.
Yes.
This is when I really wish you could make trip attacks with bows. That is a 22 to hit.
22 will hit.
Another 6 points of damage.
All right. You heard it just a little bit more.
I'm going to use my move action to switch my... This is fucking crazy. I'm going to do it. It's stupid, but I'm going to do it. I'm going to switch it to my clockwork. Where is it? The clockwork exert stabilizer. I'm going to have it so it emulates 15-foot tall masterwork stilts. And I'm going to use my swift action to activate that and keep myself up 15 feet. And we'll see if I can make the acrobatics check to fucking stand. Because this is, masterwork stilts for... Alright, I got to double check this. So... Fuck, there is no goddamn way I can stand. That's 5 times 18.
Can you not make it a ranged weapon?
No, I can't. It's a melee weapon only.
Shit. Did it be a throwing weapon?
Yeah.
I mean, yes, it could be. I don't have any good throwing weapons that aren't just regular throwing weapons, and it's a move action to make it each time.
Yeah.
Fuck it. Yeah, this DC 100 acrobatics check to keep standing on 15 foot still. Let's do it, baby.
Oh, DC 100?
Nope. Uh-huh. It's a DC 10 plus a plus 5 to the DC for each foot above 2 feet of elevation your stilts provide.
Wait, what's happening?
Fucking god.
So I attacked him twice with my my short bow, and I made that hit successfully. Then I made a new shadow weapon, not thinking through the consequences of it. It's a shadow weapon that lets me emulate Masterwork stilts. And I made 15-foot Masterwork stilts. What I forgot to factor in is that the acrobatics check for anything above 2 feet is brutal, and it's a DC 100 acrobatics check to stay upright on 15-foot stilts. So I'm assuming I take fall damage?
Yes.
Cool,
you're going to take, now I'm rolling well, 6 points of fall damage. As you miss the pool and hit the stone.
It's better than the spikes.
Yeah. Well, would you like me to roll splash damage directions to figure out which way I'm going? Like splash weapon mishaps?
Yeah, go ahead.
I'm going to pull up the... Got to pull that up because I don't remember what that roll is because I'm not built a splash weapon build in a fucking minute.
I think it's a D8 and you just go around the circle, right?
Cool. That works for me. So, one starting directly on top of me north, going clockwise. Yeah, 3 puts me on the spikes.
Okay.
So, wait, don't you fall 15 feet? Like...
That's true. I would fall 15 feet, so 3 would put me onto Trent.
Well, that's not ideal.
It's also, I would like to argue, factoring in the 15 feet, that arc of a fall, that's more than a 15-foot drop for fall damage.
Oh, fucking god.
This was a terrible...
It even does, because you're not falling straight, so you're not, like, accelerating at the same speed.
You'd accelerate the same downward, right? That's how the physics works on that.
Yeah, you would have the same speed downward over that arc that you would just falling straight.
I wouldn't know. I'm an art student.
It's like that old experiment where you'd, like, you drop a ball and you send it down a ramp at the same time, and they both...
Mm-hmm. Come with the I've same also ball. Seen it with, like, doing it with, like, a pendulum.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah.
Can I make the DC 15 acrobatics check to ignore the first 10 feet of a fall?
Let's see.
I'll say go for it.
That's an 18, so yes.
Okay.
I managed to pull out a net neutral on this bad decision.
Yeah. Just you barely managed to avoid Trent and hurting yourself too, but you are now over right next to him.
That probably
I think you were doing
probably...
better with the bow.
I have one last question that does no favors for me. 15 feet would have put me 5 feet put me in the square below her, correct?
Correct.
Oh, does she get an attack of opportunity?
No, because it's not. It's forced movement. And forced
Thank
movement
you.
Doesn't
okay.
yep. attack of opportunity. Welcome to Pathfinder, Sam.
I hate this.
This game is like, hey, what if algebra was a game?
It's insanity.
It's normally not this crazy.
No. So here's... Anytime Justin joins, it becomes like three times. It's like going more up 2 years in math classes.
Jake, I have a couple questions.
Yes.
First, so she just flew directly straight upwards out of this square, right?
Yes. She would be in that
square. So does that mean, is she in this square?
Yes, I had her in that square over there because...
Yeah, because Justin was there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, she's right there.
Second question, she flew, 15 feet out of 3 feet below the surface of the ground. So that puts her somewhere in the neighborhood of, like...
Okay, if we're counting negligible stuff, she flew 23 feet up.
So she's got a fly speed of at least 30.
My question is, can I hit her with color spray? Because by my math, she's 20 feet in the air. I'm more than 5 feet tall. It's a 15-foot cone.
Yes, you can hit her.
Here we go. So, for the purposes of this spell, because of my oracleness, you will subtract 4 from her hit dice to determine the effects of the spell.
Okay.
It's pretty cool.
And what's the save?
Color spray. The save is... Please tell me it's high. 15. Will save.
Oh, will, okay. That is
high, will?
Just a failure.
Oh, 14. Thank God. Okay, so okay, you gotta tell me how many hit dice she has.
With the -4, 2.
2?
Yes.
That's very good. So 2 hit dice or less, the creature is unconscious, blinded, and stunned for 2d4 rounds.
Nice! Right back into the water?
I guess.
She would fall since her flight is not magical.
Yeah,
I'm assuming it's with wings.
Yep, it is wings.
8 rounds! Oh, yes!
Yes! Nice!
That's enough to drown!
She is unconscious, blinded, and stunned for 8 rounds, then blinded and stunned for 3 more rounds, and then stunned for 1 round.
Wow.
Okay.
Oh, very nice.
Okay.
Hell yes.
Hold on, wait, where's the fuck?
I will try to catch her before she falls into the water.
Why?
Go ahead and roll a dexterity check. Reflex.
Yeah. Oh, reflex save?
Yep.
I'm not great at these. Yeah, I'm better than... 15.
Okay, I'd say that's enough to catch her.
Does anybody have a bottle or anything like that? A sack? Just
I
saying.
Think she's a bit big for a bottle.
If it's a big bottle.
I have a...
I really think we should just kill her.
Or we could just chop off her limbs, heal her, prevent her from dying, question her, then kill her.
No, I'm not doing that. I think we should just kill her.
I'd rather not. If we can avoid it.
It's okay, I was never a fan of the bug method.
I'd rather not kill her. I mean... We've got a prisoner. We've done it before.
It is a very inconvenient prisoner to keep.
There's nothing stopping us from going back up.
I'm gonna get rid of the...
Oh, how's Trent stilts. Doing?
Yeah, if I had
I'm gonna check on him.
Was,
yeah, while I'm
I was
here.
Gonna jump off the platform and go check.
Okay.
But nobody has like a sack or anything like that?
I have a sack.
I really think we should kill him.
Gonna be honest, you can kill something in a sack just as easily.
Trent?
Trent does wake up. He was unconscious for 3 rounds.
Oh.
Either way, we need to make a decision quickly.
Just fucking set it down.
So you can kill her?
Or do we want to do non-lethal? I do a pretty mean, specific non-lethal... attack.
I'm going to say at this point, it's been three rounds for trying to decide if you're going to kill her.
While we're talking, I'm just going to do something to help keep her unconscious for longer. I'm going to summon my... I'm going to switch it to a stun baton. And I'm going to attack with the stun baton.
Oh, that's going to hit.
Okay, cool, cool, cool. So she is going to take 4 points of non-lethal damage.
Okay.
Oops, sorry, hold on. I am on the wrong character sheet. Stun baton melee. She is going to take 6 points of non-lethal bludgeoning damage and 3 points of non-lethal electricity damage.
Okay.
I mean, at this point, it's no better than murder. Just add
yeah, you hit her and...
She wakes up, she's going to try to kill us. She's a fucking spellcaster. Doesn't matter
as
if she's in a bag or not.
You hit her with the stun baton, you see the electricity actually, like, arcs around and disperses over her instead of actually going to hit her.
Fucking immunities.
We need to just kill her. She's too much of a liability to keep alive.
I don't like that.
I'm going to say this. The middle ground here is as my brother... what is his name? Darius always says, when you're dealing with an enemy spellcaster, you can't cast spells with broken fingers.
No, absolutely not.
Yeah, but if we tie her up...
She can still cast spells.
Yeah. Well, you didn't have any... Hold on, Edan, you didn't have anything
been
to say when you killed those goblins.
What was that?
You had no issue murdering goblins.
It wasn't murder then, it was self-defense.
So is this.
Are you kidding? Ugh.
Fine.
Drop
fine,
her.
I'll leave you men
yeah,
to
yeah, I drop her.
Bubbles.
Coup de bras.
I will leave the room.
Coup de gras. Okay, go ahead.
Hold on. I need to remember. I believe it's just an auto crit, right?
It is. Auto crit and then save against the damage.
Okay, so I'll roll the damage. Twenty-three damage.
All right. Fortitude save. Plus the damage dealt.
So that's a save 33. DC 33.
Oh, that's not even. She rolled a natural 20 and could not make that. So she's very dead. Oh no, wait, you did 23.
So if it's 10 plus the damage dealt. Oh, she has DR.
She has DR. And that's still more than she can do. Mm-hmm. Yeah, she's dead.
Well, on the less bright side, any of the loot that she's got is too tiny for any of us to use.
Are you wanting to loot her?
We probably should, right?
We definitely should. She could have something useful.
All right, we'll end after this. But you find on her... a very nice, beautiful dagger, the one that's in her picture. She has a small tiara.
Can I cast Detect Magic?
Go ahead. You do cast. Detect, the dagger is magical.
Okay.
The tiara is just a tiara?
Tiara is just a tiara, and you find an obsidian unholy symbol, that same three-eyed jackal.
We should take that for study.
Yeah, given some renewed context, there's stuff carved in the walls and stuff. Can I try to make another religion check?
Go ahead.
Plus you got all that blood pumping from combat.
Can I try to identify 17. The dagger?
Go ahead.
A 17 religion check.
17, okay. 17, with the added context, you're pretty sure it's Lamashtu. Is the god. Mother of monsters.
It's our old friend Lamashtu.
27 to identify.
It is a plus one cold iron returning dagger.
Holy shit.
It deals 1d2 damage.
Oh, okay. Small.
Oh my
tiny.
God.
Resizing magical iron. Weapons is a 5e thing, right?
Yeah. Yes.
Small plus one cold iron returning dagger. Oh, here. No, I'm not going to call it a small plus one cold iron returning dagger. I'm going to call it a plus one cold iron returning pocket knife.
It's perfect.
I think letter opener would be better.
Letter opener? Okay.
She's a tiny creature.
Oh, it's a tiny weapon.
The dagger is like this big.
Oh my gosh.
Jeez.
It's tiny.
Toot Toot from Dresden Files.
Yes.
That's why they gave us a plus two weapon this early.
It needed it.
Or no, that's not even... No, because returning itself is worth like two enchantment levels, isn't it? So that's like a...
Returning's a plus one.
Oh, is that just a plus one? Okay, so...
It's a plus one.
Yeah,
it's a plus
I just two. Built overall, a Magus, so I know.
Overall plus two. Yeah. But it's tiny, so it's literally fucking unusable.
If you ever want to deal 1d2 damage to someone,
it's just for poison applications.
That is definitely a sell.
I don't know how small is Volette.
Sure. I'm sure you could build it down and build a cold iron toothpick or something.
Plus two returning for plus two. One returning cold
you
iron toothpick.
It's too bad there's not rules for what it would cost to transfer an enchantment to a different weapon.
There is in Pathfinder 2e.
That makes work. That makes.
Yeah. The Mash 2, you say?
Yeah, that's at least what this looks like. Then I'll just hold up a tiny little holy symbol.
Still feel bad about killing it?
Yes, but.
Called self-preservation.
Are you going for a swim?
I'm gonna
splooshy, splooshy.
Sit down and dissociate in the fountain for a minute.
Here's a question. What's up with this altar?
So you see, looking at it, you see this orangish, it's an, almost looks like lava, but it's translucent like water. It's boiling, frothing, and you see steam coming off of it, but you don't feel any heat.
It is Dorito water.
Is it tech magic?
Gross. It's evil eagle bath water.
No, it was bright when you came in. It's a little dimmed from after she summoned this spawn.
Is Nyrelion's detect magic still up?
How long does that last?
Because I feel like that's like a minute per level, isn't it?
Yeah, I keep it up for 2 minutes when I cast it, so yeah.
Okay, so yeah, it's
and that's within
definitely
60 feet
magical. Conjuration.
Should
I'll start
is
that
there
over.
A way we can or, get rid of this?
Oh, purify food and drinks work last time.
This is for the show. Yeah,
alternatively,
I guess I'll try it, Jake.
Alternatively, we could just consume the charge. She activated that with a drop of blood, right? So we could just put another one in, summon the next creature out, and kill it.
Yes, I suppose we could, but do we know we won't just keep spitting them out forever?
Well, the glow faded after the first one left, so I presume it's probably empty-able.
What do we think?
Does it cost you any resources to try purify food and water?
No, not at all.
Might as well try it. If it doesn't work, we have a backup.
Very well. Yeah, I'll try it out.
Okay. Yeah, you go ahead and try it out, and it doesn't. Nothing changes.
Man.
So we could consume it.
Can I try to make like a religion check to see if there's a way that
consume
like
the evil Dorito?
Get it into yourself.
Not what I meant by consume.
It's perfect.
I don't know how you eat Doritos.
Well, I think we have
wet with this is chopsticks.
Oh,
yeah,
man.
All snacks. Dude, seriously, eat all snacks with chopsticks. Saves your fingers.
And soggy, right?
Oh, yeah. Just soak up in Mountain Dew.
Okay. Anyway.
So
just... Do we want to consume the rest of the charges? Or...
I suppose that's the thing.
And that is what right. We will do next time.
Okay.
Hold justice. Hidoki, well, will you be joining us next week or no next week?
More than likely not.